Hey, Ken. Hope you're doing well. Let's do another quick audio check here. I was fucking around with some Jurassic World stuff. I'm sure we're going to get 75 million flags on this one. But hey, whatever. How's it sound? Hope you're doing well. Love that John Williams score, though, right? How's that? That should be, I think that's like bang on, maybe even a little quiet. Let me actually bring up just a, there. I think that should have it. Yeah. Okay, cool. Let me go grab a coffee and we'll start in just a couple. Thanks, buddy. Okay. Jurassic World Evolution 2. Have you guys seen any of the stuff for this at all? Have you experienced any of the crazy audio or the fun nuances of the story or anything like that? Honestly, probably not. It's a fairly new game. And if you haven't purchased it, get it on a sale if money's tight. But if you can't, you've only played the first one about 100 hours. Well, as I understand it, it's basically the same as the first, essentially. It's just got a couple of grown extra features and that sort of stuff. It's just built up a little bit. So we're going to do I didn't realize it had all my autosaves. We're going to start right at the beginning of this regular campaign. It's going to dive into it right from there.
Jurassic World. This is where our story begins. The scientific breakthrough without any consideration of the consequences.
How's that audio?
So nature did what it does and unleashed chaos. This time, we were deeper into the illusion of control, and the chaos brought something much worse. And for a moment, we remembered how precious life is. Time has a funny way of softening our memory of what it's like to lose control. And ambition. Ambition
better.
Is a persistent thing. For the dinosaurs left behind, time was becoming immaterial. From miracles of science to assets destined for exploitation. Awesome. Perhaps it's time to reflect on the true nature of nature. An endless cycle with one goal, survival.
Yeah, hard pass that.
And this means that dinosaurs and humanity have to find a way to work out their differences.
Okay, let me just take a couple of tweaks there. I was basically just up and down in the one main slider, but I know what you're looking for there. If you didn't catch that right at the end, it did say the Department of Fish and Wildlife on the helicopter. And that's going to be something that's actually happening in the movies moving forward. So I did actually post that video on the Discord, so you can take a look at that
to us,
when you get a sec.
A desert is a wasteland devoid of anything but the most extreme examples of life. But creatures once thrived in these lands hundreds of millions of years ago. Given the geological history that we're dealing with, dinosaurs walking among the tumbleweeds isn't that much of a stretch. The current situation, where dinosaurs are running wild, is untenable to those in charge, well, those that think they're in charge. So, we're left with a problem or an opportunity. This is where you come in. They've ignored my warnings before, but maybe this time with you, it's going to be different. I'm willing to embrace the uncertainty.
Maybe even the chaos, right? Right? Because, you know, Ian Malcolm gets all chaosy.
Okay, I guess an introduction is in order. I'm Cabot Finch, Assistant Director of the U.S. Department of Fish and Wildlife. I know it sounds important, because it is. But let's not get bogged down in labels and titles and organizational flowcharts. I'll make this easy. You work for me. See? Nothing to it. You'll be working with the experts. This is Claire Deering and Owen Grady.
And yes, we have first-hand experience with the dinosaurs. I'm the former operations manager at Jurassic World. Owen and I actually helped build the park. And unfortunately, we were there to witness its destruction. And this is Owen. He works with velociraptors.
You could call me a dinosaur wrangler, though officially I'm an animal behaviorist. I was just building a level of trust with them when this happens.
Okay. So we'll need to get a few things in place ASAP. Start with a response facility, equipped with both a Ranger Team 4x4
and a Capture Team helicopter.
So, anybody play Dino Crisis? Anybody know about this game? Dino Crisis? There's a little Dino Crisis in there. And my wife was a big fan of that game when she was growing up. And I was like, hey, dear, come check this out. You get to like drive a Jeep and go shoot dinosaurs and shit. She's like, it's not the same, but cute. So it's one of the things that I thought was kind of fun in here. Evolution finds a way. The dialogue that they gave Goldblum in this is just, chef kiss. It's so good. And he delivers so well. By the way, the lady, oh my God, what is her name? It's Howard, something Howard. It's actually her too. She's actually doing those voices as well, and she does a great job with that. I think she's just as great a director as her dad too. That's really funny because it's like, well, she got the eye like he did. So we'll get into some of the nuances of what each building and stuff does, and as we go through it, but you'll pick it up pretty quick as we go along. There's not too many, especially if you guys are coming from the Hearts of Iron, where there's like 8 million variables. This game's fucking easy. There's like seven. It's great. Not Laura Dern. Laura Dern was in Jurassic Park. This is the one from Jurassic World. I forget her name, but there
Next
it is. Claire
step,
Deering is the
building
character.
Building a backup generator, then feeding the energy it creates to the response facility, and also make sure the building is connected to the PATH network. It only does us good if it's operational.
Bryce Dallas Howard, thank you, Flame and Rouge. Sorry, I had to. I was in, okay, hang on, let me pause it.
We may have trouble tracking this dinosaur from the ground.
No, there's a story, hang on. Owen's chatting, we'll let him finish it.
Then, the sensible thing is to take a capture team helicopter. You can trank it from the air.
See? I like the way I think.
Okay, so, in the early days of D&D, you played a thief. Okay, well, let me hit the right button here if I can. Owen's chatting. Wrong one. There we go. New buttons, you know how it is. Early days of D&D, you played a thief. Okay, it wasn't a rogue. Okay, and then eventually they changed it to a rogue. And I remember when they brought it in, everyone was like, what the hell is a rouge? It ain't CFL football, kids. Fucking Dungeons and Dragons. Anyway, let's get into it. So, yeah. just reminded me of that. All right, so the gist of this game has two really main first components. The one we're going to talk about right away is power. Okay. Was it really? That's actually kind of funny, actually. That's good. I like that. The power problem in Jurassic Park is the same as in Jurassic World Evolution 2. Electricity is clutch. You need it, and it is something you just cannot go without. The catch is, of course, backup generators. Run on gasoline. Gasoline's expensive, and you can't run the park on a generator. So you will, in your own plays, eventually need to get to the point where you're actually getting something other than a generator going. You'll need power stations and whatnot. But for this, the first play, we'll get into that. So we're going to grab our beep beep ranger team here. We need to locate and tranquilize the nearby wild baryonyx. All right. No, we don't want that one. We want this one. Yeah. Direct control. Fly a helicopter. I'm pretty sure you can actually do like first person views and shit. Where is it? Aim, photos, sense. Oh no, maybe not on this one. Maybe it's the other one. Where is the stupid thing? Dinosaur. Oh, there he is. There he is. We're gonna fly our fish and wildlife.
I should probably pull one of these over my mouth so that we can pretend like we're actually on a helicopter. Fuck, stop. Who's flying this thing? Jesus. There you go. Okay, get the gun. I can't shoot with one hand. Hang on. This isn't easy. Okay, ready? Come on.
Misconfirmed.
Oh, misconfirmed. Fucking suck. Come here, where's the damn thing? Oh, God, you'd think I've never played a first person.
We do hours of Red Dead on Sundays. You'd think I'd learn how to aim one of these fucking tranks. Come on, man. Look at how small is this dinosaur. It's like fucking enormous. I'm going to put it right in his face. Oh, shut up. Oh, eat me. No, actually, don't do that. I think that is a meat-eating thing. Oh my god! Welcome to Jurassic World Evolution. Can't play the game. Stupid animal. You wonder you're extinct, asshole. Stop. Get in the water. You're slower there. I've mined it. There you go. Right in the kisser. Right in the butt. Yeah, go sleep in the water, piece of shit.
Claire, this is Owen.
Getting flashbacks to the arson.
After successful.
So there's quick key commands and drown.
Really?
That you can use on these, and some of them are really nice and easy.
It's better than usual.
R brings up your response facility, and then T brings up your med lab.
We
need R. We
just need you to deliver.
Team.
Hey, don't I
and
always?
We want to...
Wait, you don't have to answer that.
Where is it? Why can't I? Oh, it's there we go. Sorry, I haven't played in a couple of days. Okay, transport. Yeah, we can use that. And then we're gonna just wee you all the way over into your little park. Go send a helicopter. And you'll see him fly back, and we got a new one flying in. In the bottom corner, after every shot, if you don't.
John Hammond was concerned about what would happen if dinosaurs lived in the wild. It adds a whole new level of challenge, and perhaps opportunity.
Yeah, opportunity. It's knocking. You know what it sounds like? An ankylosaurus's ass.
Asset has been collected.
So now we're just going to transport this guy over here. He's going to drop down. It's going to give us an option to go and give a little checkup on the dinosaur, and we'll do that. And we'll go say hello. We do need a name for this. So go ahead, name this first Baryonyx. What would you like? It's just only one. What would you like to call it? Look at that.
I instantly recognize this dinosaur. Kind of hard to forget once you've been trapped in a room with one. We couldn't save that Baryonyx, but we can certainly help this one.
Can we? Can we help it? Let's show those stats. So here's the crux of the game. This is the base mechanic of it.
There's not a lot out there for the dinosaur
make
to consume.
Make the dinosaur
so
happy.
We'll need a feeder inside the perimeter.
We'll call him Broadside.
Enclosure.
We'll just call him Broadside.
Hungry dinosaurs make me nervous.
Can't disagree with you there.
There we go. That's a great name. I love it. So easily in here, the second tab over, the comfort one, and you'll see it's like, oh, I don't know what to do. So then you're like, okay, this is easy. You pull up your ranger team, the R, and you say, hey, buddy. And he's like, what? What's up? And you go check on this dinosaur. And he's like, cool. And he's going to go do that. There he is. And now he's like, oh, you need stuff in here. But we're just going to wait to see what it actually is. Baryonyx, McBaryonyx face. Next. We'll do that next. We're going to get a couple of dinosaurs in this one. This is the first one. So it kind of gives you the crux of everything. It's, you know, how to put a power station down, how to capture a dinosaur, how to take a picture of a dinosaur. Because there's actually... a little bit of cash you can earn in game when you take a picture of dinosaurs. They, you know, you get a little money here. I'll actually show you really quickly here. So here's our ranger. We'll take direct control and you can F take photo and click, and it'll give you a little tally score of how much money you can get for whatever we did. So composition, multiple dinosaurs, that sort of thing. Some of them are actually kind of difficult and you will actually have to do multiple photographs just to get the money to, get out of here. Fuck, he's angry. Get out of here. Fuck. Jerry, open the door! Safety. Most of my games developed into an arena where dinos fight to the death for my pictures. I'm gonna do this. We are gonna do this. We're gonna actually have bets and everything. I'm sure it's violating several laws in many countries, but we need to get a feeder. For the dinosaur, he's gonna get really pissed and start just like rummaging around and looking for people to eat. So there he is. He's missing some fish. I'm just gonna pause. We're gonna edit the environment. Give you a little fish feeder because he likes, you know, fish. Z and X will rotate the axis of your component. But sometimes you need more space or there's an animal in the way, so you just gotta move it around. That should be more than enough for him. Usually with the predators, I found some of them are really good at finding their stuff. Others are not. Vehicle sounds very loud. You know what? Let me actually just go in and we're going to just tweak audio settings here really quick. Because there's a few that you can see there's some extras here. So we said sounds were very loud. We're going to bring them down to 70. We're going to take voice at max. We're going to bring main to 40 and music to 75, 80. We'll try there for now. That should be a good place to start. We'll go with it for a moment. We'll see how it goes, because it's you know, I've got the game settings are basically back to where they need to be, so. Or, well, is my meters go anyway, but. So let's make sure he's, oh, and he needs rock. Now rock component can come in two ways. You can either use, like, a physical placed rock. These things will actually, the car was making your sub vibrate. Nice. Should we go for another drive? You can add these guys, which are great, but they're not really... this is probably, there's a couple of things in the game that are like, that's a little nitpicky quirk, but this is one of them. And although the rocks really are decoratively nice, you see how you can't really place them, so they sort of catch together, as it were. So it's sort of unfortunate in that way, but you can see you can make some nice little rock features regardless. I'm sure Biffa would be really, really pleased with those rock features. It'd be fine if there were people trying not to sleep in the house. Tell them to wake up. Come watch the show, assholes. Who sleeps through quality programming like this? The other thing you can do is you can paint underneath the water and they're like, hey, that's great. I love that. It sort of works as like a double layer bonus. And then, of course, your radial option here increases and decreases the size of your shit. So he really is just, he's basically okay. He just needs a bit more. And so you can actually start painting with your slider here. You'll see, and he's like, oh, this is, but I think this is the rock he actually wants. Yeah, there you go. See, now he likes that one much better. And so we're just going to add a little more in there. Oh, yeah. Rockify. There you go. You know what? Fuck it. Make a bit. Oh, they're happy dinosaur. That's right. Happy. Happy cat. Just a happy, happy cat. There you go. That's all he needs. Little rocks. Little fish. Pool in the desert. That's a happy broadside. That's right. That's his name. How did we get that name for him? Well, it's funny you should ask. Where's the house? And, yeah.
Good to go on this end.
Copy. Okay. We need to get a full assessment of the dinosaur's health. Utilize a ranger team vehicle. Owen will help you get a status of the animal's overall welfare. Then we can plan our next move.
We really need that? A plan? I mean, I've always been more of a just make it up as I go kind of guy.
Tell you what, if this doesn't work, we'll try your way.
That sort of sounds like a plan.
Well, we already know the dinosaur's happy because we did that already, but let's get our ranger post.
We can't replicate what we had on the island.
These
still have to do
help
what we
you
can
see
to get the dinosaurs more comfortable
what the dinosaur's
with their
up to.
Surroundings
and it's sort of like an automatic
Arizona.
Tool for you to use to do the checkups.
Drinks by the pool?
I'm going to actually toggle the snap function
asking?
Just so we can make a nice pretty...
Or
thing. This looks like that caged Gennaro got eaten
okay,
by.
Claire, how about we add some preferred terrain to their pens instead?
Yeah.
Better?
Yeah. We'll add that ranger team. Hit R, click on that. We're going to add a task. And just click on the ranger post.
We've
now, you do the same thing actually with the
closer.
Capture team
that's
as well. Every predator cage you have, you must
enclosure.
Do this.
It sounds crazy.
Because as soon as they
know,
get out, they'll get
work.
Tranked.
Trust me.
But if you don't do it, they'll just, you know, run around and eat people. Ask me how many times I've made that mistake.
I'm getting reports of dinosaurs running freely around the facility, Claire.
The reports may be accurate, but they don't paint a complete picture of our current status.
Angry dinosaurs on the loose. What am I missing?
They're not angry. They're simply acting on instincts. The more threatened the dinosaurs feel, the more hostile they'll become.
Especially if they sense survival is at stake.
But it is. Both theirs and ours.
Yeah, but only we know that.
Now, anyway.
We'll start by tranquilizing one of the dinosaurs from the helicopter, and then have a transport team bring it back to the facility.
Great. Do it.
All right. How did that audio sound? Was that okay? I felt the voices were a bit quiet there. Or was that just me? I gotta muck with these settings until I get them right, and then we don't have to fart around with them again. But I am gonna make that modification. Oh, no, that's not the one I'm looking for. I want the... Don't restart... Fuck, I did that once. That was really late game, and I was so sad about it. Okay, we're gonna bring main up a lot. Music down. The equal amount. Sound effects as well. Just to sort of keep that as is. And that should hopefully be what we're looking for. All right, let's hop into the helicopter. Here it is. How's that feeling? That feels a lot more steady, I think. Yeah, okay. So what are we looking for here? I think a Triceratops. Yeah, there they are.
Hi.
Oh, there's three of them. What would you call three Triceratops?
Bring it around.
We find an old Arizona. Oh, for the... Hey, I got it! Yay! Oh, right in the soft spot behind the thing. There we go. A crowd. That's not funny. Did we get him?
Negative
we get him?
Contact.
Nope, negative. We're gonna shoot him in the toes. Oh, I got him. There you go. Yeah, eat this. Eat that one, too. You know, sleepy time. Clank, clank. Okay. His buddy's just like, fuck this. I'm taking a nap. A tricycle. No, come here. Come here. Fuck you. Stupid asshole dinosaur. I'm gonna make chicken wings out of your ass. It's gonna be good. World's freshest wings. There you go. Have a sleepy time. Have a sleep. Night, night. That was great. All right. Let's try. Oh, you know what? I need a cage for these guys to go. Hang on a second. Here's drive over here. I'm WASD.
Down I go.
Right? We'll do more tranking later. The cages are garbage at first, but you can actually, on most dinosaurs, get away with the rank 2. There is a shift function here. If you can see, I'm actually going to turn it on and off. So it goes from a dashed line to a solid straight line. The dashed line, really good for making curves and bent shapes.
That's what she said.
Sorry, I had to. The straight one is fantastic, obviously, for just grid snapping. And so we're just going to do a... No, I didn't want to talk to you. Fuck, I accidentally hit the thing here. We're just going to do a quick cage here. Nothing really big, nothing really fancy. Not really going to get into that in this one. Bing, bing, bing. There is some quirks that happen with the snapping tool in this, but that's not really unusual to any grid building game. Actually, you can see this is the example right here where it's not snapping, even though it should be. So let me show you my solution on this. It's kind of an amusing one, but it really is a matter of trial and effort. And the game has, if you can see, there it is. So you deleted the one piece, put it in the other side, and then it snaps the other way. Way you go. Fucking Dennis is your uncle. I don't know. Maybe it's Jerry. Gates are required for your guys to get through, but I like having a main access, like this is a main access, and then I like having a through access so they can just go from cage to cage, basically. But when you build your fences, you need just a bit of time. Now, we've got the game on just regular speed. You need just a little bit of time for the cages to actually, like, be produced and built. But if they're electric, they're automatically electrified as long as it's connected to an existing source. The cement walls take forever to build, but they are the best ones. And you gotta, you know, go through the research and get that later, so. So there we go, and you can see we're just gonna let that fence finish up. Now we know that the dinosaurs are gonna need some stuff, first and foremost, a little bit of water. So I'm just gonna make sure that they have that, just really nice and easy, just a little puddle. And when I transport my dinosaurs, I'm actually gonna put them next to this. So they're gonna get one of their creature comforts right away, so they're not gonna be like freaking out and going all crazy. They're like, oh my God, I'm starving, I'm thirsty, I need water, and breaks through your gates immediately. You make double gates with an area between so the dinos can't run right into a different pen. That sounds really safe. Why would you do that? I don't think I've ever even thought to do that. I've only just done this shit. I'm like, oh, build a cage, throw it in. Ken didn't have a dino fight club, apparently. Well, he did, apparently, but it's so damned organized. This is Cam Shit Kano Web. Not wrong. All right, looks like our cage is actually built. Let's transport these dino s'mores and let's send them on over. So we're gonna get our F button to transport. We're just gonna click. By the way, if you're playing a regular game, you can actually sell your dinosaurs through this and get a couple of bucks. Not easily, but yes, you can profit on the illegal sale of dinosaurs. And we're gonna get into that. Oh my God, does this game have some amusing things? And yeah. Illegal dinosaur activities are one. Okay, so deliver you over there. Collection. Yeah. Where's the next guy here? We'll take you, and then we get to do this. This is one of my favorite things. When I got this game, all I could think of was, I gotta show you guys this. Because some of the stuff doesn't really make sense logistically, and some of the stuff is like,
on route to pick up the asset.
We would need an air traffic control center, and we're missing one, apparently. Because, I mean, right now, I got three helicopters in the air. That's like a military maneuver, right? Like, look at these guys. Fucking helicopters at Chernobyl weren't that close, right? All right, let's speed this up. Let's have some fun.
Commencing asset transit.
Go flying, little dinosaurs. Whee!
Transporting asset.
Little did they know, they flew.
Has been transported.
There we go. So now we can see they've landed. They're all gonna be, roaming around and looking for ship. They immediately fell fucking asleep. Oh, see, yeah, he went and fucked right off. He's all pissed off. He's gonna be like, I don't like shit. So, again, Ranger team hasn't come over here, so you can quickly build a Ranger post. Try to have them so that they overlap. You can see the radial circles there. You can kind of put them like that, and it'll be okay. But I like to just sort of, and then in each one's cage, and we'll get our Ranger team. We will add a task, and there you go. And then he should come right around and start looking for these guys. Now, I don't remember what they eat, if it's the ferns or the nuts or what. That sounded really awful. We needed the shitty recorder version of the theme. Right. I'll see if I can find my recorder. No, I'm not doing that. I don't have one. But we'll figure it out once the Rangers get there, and we'll give them the food they want. Cause this guy, I'm pretty sure this guy's gonna freak out. So What did we decide on for names for these guys?
Overall, I'd say our operations are improving.
Oh, yes. Now we want to
I'm
look at
confident
the dinos.
We may get a handle on this right. yet. But I'm also concerned, specifically about our biodiversity. Still, for now, let's focus on getting the dinosaurs safe and secure, as well as building some additional viewing galleries the DFW staff can use to monitor the animals.
So the viewing galleries, when you put them on your fences, there is actually a flip. You can rotate them and flip them. And so that way, if for some reason it ends up actually going this direction, you're like, well, that's not the viewing area. You can see the viewing grid is that giant radial. And then that way you can have people walking in and looking at the ship. So, yay. And then of course it needs a path. And the pathing system in this is some of my favorite pathings in any city building theme park enterprise I have ever played. It's really very intuitive. It's a quick system. You can see how fast I'm managing it. I don't have a ton of hours in this game, not nearly as many as say like Hearts of Iron or World of Warcraft, but really love the intuitiveness of that pathing system. So to the team or person or persons who developed it, like fucking pat yourself on the back. That was a game saver. And we're gonna put one as well. So that way we can have the Triceratops is viewable and the Baryonyx. Oh, broadside. Yeah, I'm a bit sad. I didn't even know that there was a first one. And it's funny because Canuck can actually attest to my addiction level for sandbox games is it's always been there. He and I used to work together a long time ago. And so one day I was sort of like a shift body. So if they needed an extra person, he could give me a call and I'd go and work. And I had stayed up super, 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 super late. I think until like, you know, at least the sun had been up for a few hours. And he calls me. And I'm dead on the phone. I'm like, what? I don't even think I said what. I think I like grunted. And he's like, "We got you want a shift today?" And I'm like, ugh. And he's like, "Pepsi, Pepsi, Pepsi." And my brain sort of starts to recognize what he's trying to do. He's coaxing my brain to the caffeine, get it going. And finally he asks, "Did you stay up all night playing Zoo Tycoon?" Yeah. Yeah, I did. It was a great game. All right, Triceratops are now awake and happy. We've checked our shit. They need ground fiber. So let's give them some ground fiber. Fiber can be given in two or three areas, I think it is. And so I did a few nights like that. I believe it. You'll notice it's got that provides ground leaf plus three. And then this one will have it as well. But you see there's different options here, fiber and tall fibers. So sometimes different dinosaurs require different things. And yes, you can actually have different ones in the same spaces. So you can have like a Brachiosaurus and a Triceratops in the same area. So you can actually manage them a little easier by having those, and you'll see there's the fruit and nut, and then there's these other ones. So this guy here's got a two for the fiber. And we know these guys are like super hungry, so we're gonna give them the three. And we're just, wee, nice, some fibrous areas there, up into these hills, around the ranger station there, and into the back area there. Oh yeah, see now they're all happy. That's pretty special. Some over here as well. Make that nice. Yeah. See, now they're all happy. But this will actually change over and it'll just crank right to 100 as soon as we start it up. There we go. Happy dinosaurs. Perfect. I know I did my best. All right. Did we get names for these three? The Rangers. Was that one of them? No, I don't think that was one of the names. We need names for our three shitty Triceratops. I got it. Wait. Sorry. I'm going to do it. I'm going to steal it from you. Ready? Here we go. Triceratops number one. He is not the alpha of this group. He's bitty. This is the leader. He's gritty. Guess what this guy's name's gonna be?
With so many
Molary and Curly.
Free, our priority has to be capturing as
good.
Many of them as
okay,
possible.
Okay, we'll do that. Mo
we
is
can coordinate
this
our
one.
Efforts from an expedition center. Get one built, and we'll take it from there.
There we go, Larry. And oh, looks like Curly's the leader. I don't actually know if that's how that worked. I don't know which was the leader. So if that was the leader, air quotes leader of the three stooges, then there it is. Oh, who farted? All right, we need what? Oh, the expedition center. Expedition center lets you go out, get new fossils. Cause in Jurassic Park, you get dinosaur DNA from fossils. In reality, you get it by reverse engineering chickens. If you'd like to actually watch the TED talk on that, it was amazing because the guy who's giving the talk is a geneticist, and he even opens the talk by saying, basically everything we know about genetics and dinosaurs started with the story from Michael Crichton. So, I mean, if that isn't the most cool fucking thing ever, I don't know. I think it is. By the way, there is actually a mention of him in a couple of places. I'm not going to spoil it, but I will tell you to look forward to it. And I think I should be able to let you be aware before it happens. I should be able to. Slap that in there. Doesn't really matter where, I guess. And there's the snap on the building. We'll just put it to the edge there. And let that build up. So there is a funny thing here. You'll notice the ranger teams just drive right through, like, the park people. Let me get him after he's done doing what he's doing, and then we'll go for a ride down the park path and show you what happens. I'm actually going to speed the game up just to... Whoop, there.
I'll be able to track the dinosaurs, but some help would sure be appreciated. Claire tells me there are some candidates to recruit. Scientists. Hopefully you could find one as rough and tumble as I am.
You didn't quite catch what happened there. The Baryonyx was a little upset that the ranger got close to him, and so he attacked it. And in doing that, you remember how I said when you set up your ranger post, you gotta attach those helicopters to it. And so he attacked the ranger team, and immediately that helicopter fucked right off. And he's like, nope, trank, dart, eat one. If you recall in the first one, people will dive out of the way as you go flying down the footpath. Sure do. Sure do. Where's that ranger team? Where's he? Returning to response facility. Perfect. Oh, that's not scary. Oh, don't honk at the dinosaur. Fuck you, fuck you. Shitty Mo, or Curly, or whoever the hell that was. Look, I'm already missing parts of my car. Well, there's some. Yeah, there's a few more. Oh, tree. Oh, fuck. Oh, okay, apparently we don't go through those trees. That's nice. There we go. Hey, Jerry. Where's my money? Jerry? First person view. Cars didn't have damage in the first one. There's two achievements actually for the cars in this. The first one is you gotta make it drive fast enough that if you hit a kick, you can go flying for like 20 feet or something like that. And then the other one is to be attacked by a dinosaur so much that it gets destroyed. Or just destroy one in general. So drive it around until it looks like this and a bit more. And then once that happens, you can actually bring your car back to your response station. Hey, Karen, how's it going? And then you'll see in the top left corner, the condition meter is actually increasing. But you have to, as the player, sit there parked here and allow that. Now, if you notice, the car's actually rolling. So I'm just going to put the handbrake on, hold the space bar. Because, you know, the Jurassic Park cars, they have problems with the clutches, apparently. There we go. So he's all good now. So recruit a new scientist. Where's the science center? What is that? This one? Control center? Emergency? Oh, I don't think I built one. Where do I need to? Operations, expeditions, shelter, arrival. Well, gotta build one, I guess. What the fuck is it? I'm good at this game. Or is it already in the thing here? Oh, it's already in the thing. Research, scientists, they're there. Recruit a new one. So then you get this screen. Ah, sorry. I don't know why I'm apologizing. There's a couple of things you're gonna wanna look at in this for what you're trying to do in your game. Now, I really like immediately her cost per minute. I wish I made 9,900 fucking bucks per minute. Jesus. Is she the CEO of this company? It's like, my God. Low cost, high reward, right? Simple math. Your recruitment costs also, you can see 400 grand, 200 grand, 300 grand. That can come back to bite you. But also there's this figure, the top bottom. You can actually max these out, but you want to find somebody who's kind of jack of all trades, master of none for a few things. And then this extra trait is usually something that comes in really beneficial. Motivated means that you can continually rely on them to do things again and again before they become Dennis Nedry. But otherwise, it's not too bad of a deal. So we're going to actually start with this lady. She's pretty decent because, yay, cheaper research is always a good thing. And then we're going to take this one because that big logistics value.
You seeing this, Claire?
Yeah, I sure am. This is our first live capture opportunity.
Let's not miss it.
We should assign that scientist you just hired to the task. Agreed?
And so that's what they're talking about right there. Oh, so every now and then, you get one of these.
I think you're still muted.
Oh, yeah. Sorry.
Oh, I thought she was talking to me. Fuck, Jesus.
You know.
Oh, my God, Cam.
Maybe a new recruit.
Oh, my God. You've been a broadcaster for too long, my dude. Anyway, so when you pair up your scientists and you get these overrun things, you'll actually decrease the duration of whatever event you're trying to do. So you see, we only actually need a 2 logistics to send this mission out. But if I do it with the additional person, it cuts the duration down. And there are things, faster expeditions, faster research, that sort of stuff. We're going to make sure we do that just so we can crank the speed juice on that one.
Before the remote capture teams return, we should have enclosures ready for the dinosaurs. Think of it as welcoming them back home.
Yeah, that's what we'll think of it as. Okay. What are we going to pick up, a stegosaurus? Jesus, I should have looked at that harder. Where is it? Expedition map. What are we looking for here? 4 stegosauruses. Okay. Damn bots. Well, you know, and it's funny, I tried to set the timer so they'd be offset a little bit. I'm gonna have to tweak it, but at least they're working this time. I don't even know what the hell happened with them not working. I swear to God, I went into the thing was on. I closed it, I go back into it, it was off. Oh, these are fun. Oh, I didn't even put a space down. Oops. Hang tight, we'll just, give me two minutes. I was gonna talk about this really quick. That the cohabitation function in the game is actually really nice. So, where is it here? Likes compies and ankies. Does not like stegos. Do not put your stegos in with those guys. Okay, that's all we're looking for. Sometimes it's good. Sometimes it's that. So you can see that little white red border. If we're inside of it, it's white. If we're outside of it, it's red. That is the park boundary. Let me just actually pull the map out, and you can see right here. That's sort of what we get to work with. The wild area, as it is in here, is just extra territory. I think it actually comes later, but we'll plop this all down together here over this side. Stego Penitentiary. That's the one I'm looking for. I'm just gonna zip that around, give it kind of a sort of space. I don't really want to make this one too far away. And then on each of those enclosures viewing galleries, you'll see there's actually connection points there, and that's what I was looking for. And then that way we can just kind of, oh wow, super straight line there, pal. Super duper. There we go. Let's kind of give you a couple of minutes. There you are. Oh, solid fencing system. This is the stuff of Hammond's dreams, you know. And then you can come in, oops, and then I was gonna say, and then you can come in here, right, and you can hit shift and it'll start that curve tool up. Oh, I didn't do it, there we go. And then you can kind of make nicer walls for the dinosaurs to kind of map into. We're gonna just kind of whoosh. So actually, you know what, here, let's do it this way, and we'll bring that out. Oh my God, Cam, buddy. Oh, dude. Yeah, about there. And oh, dude, come on, man. You can fuck. Oh, gee. There you go. And we'll just edit it together. Yay, what a nice little stego pen. Right? Stego pen. And again, we're gonna do the same thing. We'll add in a tiny little drop of water because, you know, everything needs water. Yay. Yeah, nice little lake there. And we'll wait for the stegos to arrive. They're gonna need a gate to get in, those crazy rangers. They like to fly around. You can do the same thing there where you can flip the gate door. Pick which side it is. Doesn't really matter, but if you're arranging your park with more care and attention than I've given this, it probably will. You're gonna crank that speed again so we can get that fence built. Ding 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 ding. And you'll watch those little blue lines are the to build, and the gray ones are the built. You can see it slapping down there. Ding ding. We'll wait for those stegos to arrive again. Oh, right. Shit. Power issue. As I'm just looking at it, totally ignoring all these fucking whoop de doop de doop de doop. See how it's not in the range of that grid, but if I put it in, it'll be okay? That's how it works. You could end up having some really ugly power line problems, and we will. And we'll show you some fun ways to deal with that. So there we go. We'll pop those guys down there. Oh, we didn't put a ranger station in. Let's get you one of those. And ding, ding, ding. We will. There we go. Got a ranger team on there. He's visiting post one, now two, and three. Awesome.
Delivery has been completed.
There we go. We've got Stegos. Yay. We got four of them. I know exactly what to name four.
Okay.
Well, he's the first one.
Who's watching who?
I'm not following you, Owen.
Well, it's just like the dinosaurs are always watching us, so shouldn't we be watching them?
Yes, we should. Once we have the dinosaurs comfortably settled into their enclosures, we'll need viewing galleries.
That's what I'm saying. Only you said it.
Oh, fuck, I hope I spelt that right. My God, I'm not really even sure. Did I get that right? God, I feel so stupid not being able to spell the Ninja Turtle names now. My 9-year-old self is going, "You're a dummy." Oh, what are you two doing? Hey, hey, there is no breeding in Jurassic. Wait, where are we? There's no breeding. Hey, you, ranger, wait, pause. Ranger, stop this. Direct control, stop this nonsense. That's right. Knock it off, you couple of fucking horn dogs. Stop being stupid. Oh shit, he's coming. Fuck, run. What do we spell it as? Just copy that. I don't know if that actually did. There we go. Oh, yeah, totally fucked it up. Thanks, Ken. Appreciate that. All right, what do you guys need? You need... Oh, you're still looking for your status check. Sorry, I hijacked the ranger there. That's my bad. Oh, see, now he's all, like, pissed off. He's like, fucking ranger, get out of here. He's gonna hit him. Oh, he does not seem happy about this. Here it comes. Here, oh, he's gonna... What is he gonna do? Oh, is he gonna take a shit in the water? Cue the Kirk music. Dun, 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 dun. Oh, there it is. Oh, nice hit. Oh, yeah. Oh. Oh, buddy. Oh, buddy. get an F in the chat for the ranger vehicle. How long did that take? How many minutes are we into the show here? 49 minutes even, almost. Perfect. 49 minutes to wreck our first ranger vehicle. He's panicking. The car's gonna fucking blow. This game's awesome. Oh, I love it. All right, ground fruit and fiber. He's a tall eater, so we're gonna get a little bit of each here. So we got some fiber. Let's throw that here. We'll make a bigger one at the back here. Big patch of the fibrous plants. That's where the lettuce be. Is that enough for that? Yeah, that's just enough. We'll add in a little bit more. And what was the other one? Need a fruit. Needs a little fruit. So this one has a triple fruit rating. All right, let's throw those in over this side here. Nice patch of fruit plants. And we'll put another one, just in case they get stupid or hungry, over here. Yeah, that's nice. Now you can see the open space value is actually reducing as well. And so one of the ways you can actually help that is you can literally just remove every piece of terraforming in the space and then start from new. The only thing that actually I've noticed doesn't really have a value of interest in this is terrain height. That doesn't seem to matter as much. Whereas like in Zoo Tycoon 1, you know, the big cats like to be on rocks, and that meant also elevation. So that doesn't seem to be as important in this. But that should do it now. He should, as soon as he stops panicking. Yeah, there he goes. Let's replace our ranger vehicle. Stupid thing. Buy new vehicle. 50 grand. Wow, it's an Explorer. And now they got their comfort value. They'll be happy. And you can see the Rangers going through the paddocks again, checking stuff out. I'm not sure exactly how many, we're getting a sandstorm. All right, here go the frames.
Oh,
open what? The emergency shelters.
Door section, please. As a precautionary
Owen, we have a real problem.
I'm trying, Clara, but it's just...
Well, Ren!
This is who I am.
Not you.
Dinosaurs. Tell me something I don't know.
Fucking stragglers.
Okay, how about this? There's a massive sandstorm headed our way, and it could wipe out
nice.
The facility.
Oh, broadside's
power,
out.
The safety of the dinosaurs
broadside's
could be
out.
A serious risk.
There's the helicopter.
Okay.
See if he go, he's
listen
gonna go get him.
Clara.
Oh, he's circling
we'll
Curly.
Figure this out. Have I ever let you down before?
There he
actually,
goes. There he goes. Trank time.
No.
Night night.
And I'm planning on.
Oh, he's not even gonna do
way.
It. Okay, fine. I'll do it myself. For God's sakes, go trank this guy. Sleepy time. Night night. There you go.
Everything we can do, we will do.
Oh,
we
he's just taking a
course.
Sip now.
What's
look at that,
sand?
Making it easy for us. That's a good boy. He's still getting missed. Can't hit the broadside. He's not even hitting him. There he goes. He's got a plus one to dodge. Let's get our ranger team. And he's going to be the one that fixes the fence. We'll just add a task there and go repair that fence. Now, you'll notice that he can only have... 5 tasks at a time, and that includes the automated
say,
ones.
I'm feeling pretty concerned about our current situation. As much as I'd obviously love to help out, I'm a little tied up. So, who's gonna protect the dinosaurs?
And our personnel?
Yes, of course. I mean, that goes without saying.
I'm saying it anyway.
It's just, it would be a tragedy to lose these animals again, and... By tragedy, I mean huge financial loss. And obviously an embarrassment to those in charge of the DFW.
People such as you?
Well, actually, exactly me. So, how do we avoid that?
Okay, step one, round up the stragglers and get all the dinosaurs back into their enclosures. Then we'll work on our safety ratings.
This good?
Yes, this is a plan I can support now and take credit for later.
Yay! I'm so glad I'm doing my job correctly. I tried so hard!
Arizona was secure. The dinosaurs were safe. Finch and the DFW had what they needed to keep the bureaucrats off our backs. For now. But the future? That was something completely different.
Washington. Skip, that's awesome. The referee.
Touchdown!
And no, the campaign is not very difficult in this game. It's a really nice, quick and easy introduction.
I wish we had more time to brief you, but as you know, the situation is fluid. Our Canadian friends are concerned that many of these wild animals are getting close to their border. We'd like to prevent them from crossing it. We being the CIA. My division is the DSD, Dangerous Species Division. I'm Dr. Dewar. I have an extensive background in paleo research in this very field. At Jurassic World, and now... other locations I'm not at liberty to discuss.
Yeah.
However, I have history with many of the people involved here. A poacher camp. What remains of it, anyway? Amateurs. They only succeeded in getting themselves and others killed. And making our job that much more difficult.
Dr. Dewar? Dewar.
Dr. Dewar, the dinosaurs
oh, no, it
are
is
still agitated.
Tranquilizing them would appear to be the best option at this point.
Okay. Let's do it as safely and quickly as we can.
Oh, I mean, if I must. If I must. All right. Oh god. Okay, ascend. Oh no, that ascend. Yeah, just trank him right in the cage there, buddy. Alright, here we go. Sharpshooter. Right in the face. Oh, look at that. Double knockout. Sleepy time. Okay, where's your buddy? Jimmy, eat Crack. Oh, fuck. What are you doing? Ooh, that was a great shot. Okay, wait. Here we go. Oh, you moved. You're not supposed to move. Stupid. I missed his ass. Oh, for... Right in the face. Oh, that was gold. Gold, Jerry. Is that it? I think that's it.
Just as an organization has key players, it also has key facilities that it needs to run effectively. So you should get started with the construction of an arrival building, a control center, and also a backup generator to supply power.
Well, all right. I love how the Canadian government's getting all upset about possible American and or like American dinosaurs are crossing. But they need passports or some shit. You don't think they're in Canada? Fuck, we drill them out of the damn ground already. I'm gonna knock out a couple of these walls just to make these better facilities. But I do need a couple of the, there we go, operational buildings. So the arrival point, I'm just gonna double check this map again. Where was the expansion areas up here? Yeah, okay. Oh my God, it's like a strip of land. All right, let's throw the arrival point, I think, down here. There are little like terrain map tools, like height things and whatnot you can get into for these really easy early missions. I'm not gonna really get into them too much. Let's set you, yeah, we'll go against this side here. Whee, there we go. Canadian bacon 2, dinosaur boogaloo. It's a Michael Moore expose on gun safety and tranquilizers. Oh, America, you've got such problems. All right, yeah, let's snap some of these cages together. I think that's, oh, these are all just needing repair. Is that what's going on there? Okay, let me, yay, snappity snap, steely go. That's gonna go away. These are gonna go away. That's gonna go away. This is gonna go away. Pull that one out. Take that one out. Look how small these are. Fucking poachers. It's one of the things I like in Red Dead. It's like, there's a random poacher camp. No mercy. What does he have? Cute little woodland creature. We'll all die. Yeah, I think those are all just needing repair. So you know what? I'm just gonna do this easy way. Not waste time on repairing them. We got a little money back. Put the thing back in. Way to go. Fuck, really? Is that crooked? Oh my God. Whatever. And I think that one was broken. This one was broken. Jeez, just rebuild the whole goddamn thing. You know what? I will. Actually, I will. Here, let me just do that. Bloody stupid wrecked cages. I'll put better cages in. Bigger cages. My cages are going to be the greatest cages. I need a fancy thingy and a thingy thingy and a this button there. Snappity snip, snippity snap, clippity clap. There you go. Pretty sure they're both inside of that thing too. So great. Works out good. Yay, look at that. Wonder cage. Da na na na. Greatest builder ever. Put one of these things in. Solid. Get one of these things, because you know we're gonna have the guy in there doing the stuff. We already have one? No, I don't. I gotta build that, I guess. Right there. This is like hella hell. So yep, that'll work. Really taking the care to plot out where and how this air traffic is going to work. Super important, very key. Managing these animals and the safety with things like helicopter traffic and air fuel, right? That jet fuel they use and the noise. You know, we've really taken into consideration none of those things to make Jurassic Land. Yeah, it's the one, Jurassic Land. All right. Jenny, there you are. That should be everything. I even added in the, spared no expense, right? I even added in the paleo medical. I'm sure we're going to need it eventually. It's, you know, when you get a sick dinosaur, it's where they go. Actually crank that up again. Just waiting for buildings to build. Wonderful. Oh, apparently I didn't build the control center. Oops. Need one of them too. Here. Eee, right there on Main Avenue. Let go. Stupid snap. There we go. There we go. All right. Ensure buildings are connected together with facility paths and are covered by a power genie. Jenny.
Not bad if I do say so myself. And I guess I am. But we're also going to need a response facility. Your response to this directive should be to get one built. Huh? You see what I did there, huh? response. Never mind. Don't respond.
Claire, we need to get the dinosaurs into new holding enclosures.
The ones we've already captured.
Yep, that's right.
And we'll want them awake and as comfortable as possible.
Want to see a quick trick to waking up your dinosaurs? Transport them. Seriously.
Asset to be collected.
You can wait 10 minutes almost for those things to wake up. Or you can just move them and they wake right up. They're like, oh, cool, we're awake now. I got moved. That's how it works, I guess. Let's go with it.
Asset being transported.
They are being transported. Look at that. Oh, whoa, boys. Easy there. Fuck. This is what happens when you hire
asset transportation complete.
Crazy Washington helicopter pilots. And away they go. See, now they're all happy and moving around. Whatever. Happy dinosaurs. Well, they're not really, because they're probably hungry. Uh-oh. Dun, 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 dun. I know exactly who we're naming. This clearly is going to be... Oh, my God. Is it CK or... I think it's CK, yeah. Jesus, I just don't know how to spell anything anymore. I think it's CK. That's right, Kirk. Just have a sit. He's the asshole. Oh, he's rubbing his face in the dirt. Well, that seems accurate. It seems accurate. All right, let's give you guys a little feed here. This is pretty fun to watch. My daughter, she's 6, loves watching the dinosaurs eat. It's so, daddy, what? Feed him a goat. Feed him a goat. You got it. Kirk will court the alien females. All right, ready? Now we, by the way, you can actually manually dispense the goats, but it'll automatically do it. So there's one, and we'll just like do it just so you can see how it works. There we go. Oh, there he goes. Oh, wait. Hang on. Wait, let me slow it to a speed 1. Where's the other guy? There he is. Oh, are you guys gonna fight again? Don't do it, Spock. Don't. You can't win. Just go looking for a goat, my dude. Just look for a goat. You horny bastard. What is he trying? What are you? Oh my God, where are you going? Oh, there it is. There it is. Eat it. Beautiful. Beautiful. Isn't that great? All right, what is this beef? You need what? Sand. Yeah, okay. He's probably got to use it because I know I had a cat that had the same thing. It really needed sand. So let's get some sand for it here. See if it likes this. Ooh. Is that what you're looking for, my dude? Is that it? Yeah, that's the stuff. There you go. Let's paint a whole space in here. He's like, man, you know what I really like? Sand. You know what I hate? Snow. There we go. 100%. Perfect. Beauty. And there we go. Happy dinosaurs. Now, obviously, you can get much, much more involved with how you present the spaces and the galleries. And I think in the games we're gonna do coming up, we are gonna really get into that more, just so we can enjoy it. Kirk, dude, you just territorial, ain't ya? Spock's chilling. Kirk's yelling at him. Feels accurate. The goats are running around like, fuck, hit the fence. Oh, we need a viewing gallery. Okay, let's put one in. There we go. Yeah, see, that's what I was talking about, how it's on the wrong side. We'll just get around. There we go. And we are going to need to expand our park. We always will. So you'll have to have that sort of in mind whenever you're building any of your enclosures. After the break, I'm going to show you one of the game's sort of pre-designs, if you will, for what a park could sort of start or be like. So we'll show you the San Diego one, which does actually have the dinosaur arena. I think you guys are going to kick out of that. Oh, forced control. All right, where are we going?
They had dangerous animals here?
Correct, Mr. Finch.
All right,
we
searching for species.
But
all
now,
right, here we go.
Mr. Grady, it's essential that we know where they are.
I know my dinosaurs. I'd say they're headed off in this direction.
Yep.
And do you know your dinosaurs, Mr. Grady?
Better than anyone.
But these are not your dinosaurs, per se.
Well, you're just gonna have to trust me.
Oh, wait,
on this
that
one.
Was one? Oops, that's not the brake. That's the brake. There we go. I've driven one of these before. Ah, oh, through the bush. Apparently, I damn near ran over the dinosaur. What was it? I didn't even see it. What is it? No, that's a tree. Oh, I see. I'm tracking it.
This looks promising.
I hit the wrong button, right?
Yeah, not that I'm promising anything.
Unknown species disturbance identified. Oh man, who's driving this thing? Wow, reverse is amazing in this car. Must have been those notes from that first park experience. Make sure the cars can drive in reverse at full speed. Oops, wrong. Brakes, brakes. Fuck, these things have shit brakes. I honk at it again just for you, Ken.
Everything points in this direction.
Yes. Yes, it does. Same with my car. What a lovely day for a drive, huh? Don't you think? Ooh, missed a tree. Whoa, missed it. Ooh, Jesus. Who's driving this thing? Woo! Oh, I think this is what we're looking for. Brakes!
Say what you want about the dinosaurs, but they're not subtle. Wherever they go, they leave a mark.
Sounds like someone I know.
Is it Dr. Malcolm? Because that guy...
Ooh, slidey slides! Oh, tree. We're all good.
Talk about
oh, shit, what is that?
As opposed to...
Well, you know, a certain lovable animal behaviorist whose humility has a charm of its own.
Dinosaur, where you at? I'm looking for you. Pterosaurus Rex? An Allosaurus.
I feel like we're getting close.
Apparently they were kind of assholes. Had a bit of a bad attitude. That's a bad attitude. I think we'll try and go around this tree here. Great driving, eh? About to get eaten. Yeah, that's a big boy. There is actually a mission. We'll get to it eventually. On Jurassic World when you go back to it. And it deals with a couple of loose dinosaurs. And it's like nightmare fuel. It's fucking terrifying. Oh, I think we're getting close here. It says more wood to check. Gotta check the wood. Analyze the wood.
That's what she said.
Just be ready for anything, all right?
I'm ready for anything. Anything. Oh, look. Brachiosaurus is and a Stegosaurus. Just fucking Tokyo drifting the shit out of this car. This is just great fun. Yeah! Woo! Oh, more analyzing. Whoa, video twitch.
Ambush.
Oh, there it is.
Move quickly, not too quick. You'll trigger the instinct to chase. Now move. Move!
Owen. Owen, are you okay? What is happening?
Little busy right now.
Please tell me you have things under control.
Do you want me to lie?
Yes. If it'll calm my anxiety, yes. I'm a bundle of raw nerves.
We're working the problem.
Yeah, that's what we'll call it. Working the problem. All right, here we go.
We
direct
have a
control.
Standing by.
Where is it?
Attempt
where
to
is
tranquilize
it?
The animal
where is
from
it?
The air.
Attempt. Attempt. We need success,
it? Where is it?
Dr. Dua, before it can eat Grady and the
okay,
others.
Fine. Do
no,
it this way.
Please
where is
don't
it? Oh, there
that.
He is. Oh,
you
right through the trees.
Teeth, right?
No problem.
You want me
these
to lie?
Are special helicopters. All right, here we go. Lob shot. Whoa. Yeah, you think? Okay, here we go. No, oh, fuck. Too far. Here we go. Here we go. God, come on. Stupid dinosaur. Okay. Get a nice view. Right in your... Oh, that was pretty close. Here we go. Yay! All right. Hail Mary. Joe Montana, back to pass. He looks far. The pass is wide. Interception. He's getting away. He's so fast. What? Oh, hang on. It's being stupid. There we go. Oh yeah, now I gotta try and fucking shoot it in the trees. Oh, no problem. No problem. No problem. Get my sniper scope out. Where is it? Here we go. Here we go. Ready? Give it the old Arthur Morgan shmee. Get him? Here, buddy, you can do it. This is so awful. He's gonna end up going, like, out of the park zone or something. Can't even see the damn thing. Just lobbing in the dark now.
That's what she said.
Let's get out of the trees, man. Here, you know what? I know what to do. Oh, over the tree. There you go. Oh, I see. He's all like, there's a helicopter chasing me. I'm a big scary dinosaur, but fucking helicopters scare me. Well, that and these little pink things keep raining down on him, but around him, like, you know, little psycho fairies. How many darts do we have? I don't know, but we've invested in the pink dart factory. Just sort of blindly wailing around. He's just standing still. Wait! Yay! One more. He's like, fine. I'll just stand here.
Owen, what's our status?
We're close. We have everything almost under control, but the animal is injured. We'll need to get her to a secure enclosure for observation and treatment.
I'll notify Dr. Dua.
Yeah.
Oh, me? I'm fine. Thanks for asking.
I guess we'll sort of... I guess we'll tuck that in over here. Maybe? Not a lot of space in this space. Let's do this. Let's extend this one. Because there's no visitors in these areas. So we don't really have to worry about that stuff as much as in some of the other places where you actually are like, no, it kind of is important to deal with that shit. We'll start with that for now. That should be more than enough for it. Where's the stupid thing? Hey. Dummy. What are we going to name this? You know what we're going to call him? Wait.
And the herbivores?
Because you can't see them through the trees.
What about them?
Huh? Right?
As long as
right?
they stay away from civilization, leave them in place. They'll survive in the wilderness without our intervention, right?
Given time to adapt,
woo,
yes, I'd say they will.
I guess that's something we're all going to have to get used to. Having dinosaurs out in the world.
Is that you talking, or is that the government?
Right.
Claire, I am the government.
Claire, I am the law. Have you guys seen The Judge Dredd with Carl Urban? Very fun movie. Love Carl. Great stuff. Go watch. Amazon Prime. Have you seen The Judge Dredd with Sylvester Stallone? Go watch the one with Carl Urban. Very good. Amazon Prime.
Asset transportation underway.
The Stallone one wasn't bad, but that was before they really knew how to do those fun action things. Speed that up, throw them over there. Oh, and then we're gonna need a status check, so let's get a thingy here. Get one of those guys and go, there you go. Yeah, get the Ranger on there. Ranger, add you, do this one as well. Yeah, great. Thanks, buddy. Oh, and we need a gate. Yeah, of course. Sure. There we go. And there we go. We'll put one right here too. Yeah. Gates.
Asset delivered.
Well, I guess we're gonna have to get you some food too, hey? Yeah.
Hi, Forrest.
He's like, don't talk to me. He can smell the goats. Yeah, little goat station. There we go. Some of them like to eat like just raw rotting meat or whatever. So that's the carnivore pits. That's the steaks. It's just a pile of meat. And then there's the goats like we saw in the movie. And then there's the fish feeders which go in the water. And that's if they like to eat the fishies. There we go. Live prey feeders. I gotta say I am quite excited to see how they're going to wrap this series up, because this is essentially in the in-between. So the last film, spoiler not spoiler, you've had enough time to watch it, it ended with genetically modified war dinosaurs were on the horizon, and the Claire Deering choosing to, instead of kill all the dinosaurs, giving them a second chance at life and allowing them to run free in the wilderness.
I'm going to need a paleomedical facility.
And that's where we pick this story up here.
Of the dinosaur
and the movie's
going to
come up
in.
After this.
We'll need to do a full medical scan.
All right.
I want to understand what went wrong if we're going to avoid an event like this in the future.
Should probably add that helicopter onto these. There is a thing you can do where, if you need to do like some rebuilding in your spaces, you can just trank your dinosaur, wreck your cages, rebuild them around them. They'll stay asleep for quite a while. Oh, he's missing Forest. Forest is missing Forest. I feel we should fix that really quickly. Let's actually just get him a little bit of, needs a little water and a little forest. And you can see here again, the same thing, double trees, triple trees. And that doesn't necessarily mean that he's getting the right one. Because it's like, well, if he doesn't really need some open space, he needs a little bit, not a lot. So you can actually add in those thinner trees around, and you can see that was perfect. That just added in exactly what we needed. Didn't compromise any of the space there, but we're going to add a couple more just to bring that value up. I would wager the triple trees are very, very much more. All right, I'm going to bring down one. Yeah, that's going up much more. So we'll just leave that. The problem with the density on the trees is if you have too many in a clutch, your ranger teams can't get through, and if your dinosaurs are stuck in there, they could end up dying of starvation because there's too many trees. Funny. He wanted some trees. What did you do? I choked him with the wood.
That's what she said.
Tell me that wasn't a great one, though. I don't know if you'd still... There we go. Now the water's good. All right. So we'll just let that roll. Now he needs to go to the paleomedical facility. Hit my T button. There's my mobile vet. He can go and scan shit. But you see the treatment bay is empty. So I'm going to get my ranger transport, pick him up, fly him to the vet. Oh, he requires a major injury. Oh, okay. We're going to treat him with the thing then. Okay. You add. And oh, yeah, there it is. Go scan forest. I'll go drive over there. There is actually one thing I want to show you just really quickly here. On both the paleomedical and on your ranger teams, you can actually change the cosmetics. I don't have any for this one, I think, at the moment, but I should, I would assume, have for this one. This is the button I'm looking for. Yeah. Oh, they're not unlocked for the campaigns or whatever. But yeah, there's, and then for the helicopters as well. So there is one when you subscribe to their newsletter, it gives you a beaten up 93 Jeep Wrangler or whatever it is. Yes, that is a great trick. When you have multiple enclosures next to each other, put the water under the fence separating them. 100% right. And it saves in your space so well. So, so well. So now that he's gone for the scan, he's come back and he's like, oh shit, the dinosaur has a major fracture. And now what we're going to do is, he's already tranked. We're just going to pick him up, send him over to the medical facility. And they're going to be like, who would you like to fix your dinosaur? So now this is where you can have things like welfare specialists. Apparently we don't have anybody to do anything on this, so we're just going to close. It's gonna be like, hey, is that okay? And yeah, we're gonna transport them regardless, and we're gonna go into our scientist's control room, and we don't have any people. Now you were cheap and you were a bit expensive, but a logistics specialist, we got a couple points there, so we're actually gonna fire them. Bye. Sorry, it's nothing personal, it's just business. Oh, look at this. She's $5,400 and has a nice balance of stats across the board here. This gets 28, 11. And this is a task time. This one's quite nice because it pairs basically with everybody. Like a fine wine. 3, 4, 4 at 60. And that's actually really nice. We'll take that guy. And of course, those big chunks of cash at the beginning for your hiring bonuses or whatever for them can actually add up really painfully, so be careful with that. So now that the dinosaur's on route, we have to wait. I'm gonna add a little fuel, just a little bit, because see, got fucking expensive, $400,000 to fill that jet. You can research and build a power plant for exactly that amount, by the way. So, pro tip. And there he goes. And he's going to land there. As soon as he lands there, he's like, hey, shit's gone wrong. There's your notice. And you can come over here. Assign a scientist. It'll be like, hey, who would you like in there? Morgan. Start. And that's going to cost $500,000. By the way, that cost in healing your dinosaurs, if you genetically engineer shitty dinosaurs that are always fighting and getting hurt, you will bankrupt your park. So, although I'm not saying fighting is bad for the dinosaurs. There's even things we'll get to, the audio and game we'll talk about it. But it can really cause you some serious grief. So you want to try and make sure that you do either have a bank of cash that's really easily, steadily coming in, or maybe just reconsider how you've got your environments arranged for the dinosaurs, because they might just start trying to kill each other. And they do. Oh my God, do they ever. All right, Forrest is ready. I'm going to transport him. Right back to the trees.
Heading to collect the asset.
Now, genuinely, as a game design development, I don't know what a solution would be other than helicopters. like it's almost unreasonable. What would you use, a train? You'd have to have some sort of like a train system or something. I don't know exactly how like if the San Diego Zoo had to transport their elephant, or the Edmonton Valley Zoo had to transport Lucy the elephant. Damn thing's still there.
Confirming asset delivery.
Maybe, I don't know actually. You know, how do they do it when they got to trank it? And then what do you do for a Brachiosaurus? Or a Diplodocus? Right? Because those animals are just fucking gargantuan. So the Allosaurus, now we ought to make sure he's got the comfort. Where are you at? He's missing prey. Did we not add in? Oh, we did actually, but you see the goats are over here. See, this is one of the, I'm just gonna pause this really quick here. This is one of the sort of curious features where we're getting a bit of a snowstorm, so it's sort of hard to see with the contrast. Sorry about your eyes. But there's the feeders there and there, and the goat is somewhere over here. Here he is, fucking white goat. So there's the goat right there. And you'll notice as soon as I click back on the Allosaurus, we get his radial dial up, and you see it just edges out right around where that goat and that feeder were. So we're actually going to move those so they are closer to him, and that will help him feel a lot better about where he lives. So we'll just kind of throw that in there, and we'll leave that one over there. So he has one on each side of the space. And then that should make him much happier. There we go. That is a very happy forest. Look at him having a drink out of the mud. You're not the brightest thing, are you?
Part of the healing process is to get some rest, preferably someplace comfortable.
Always worked for me. Same for the dinosaurs, I'd imagine.
You imagine correctly.
Not according to my ex.
Yes, moving on then. We want to have the animal transported and then secure and comfortable in its enclosure, if you please.
I don't know, he seems pretty happy now. So he's just like, hey, buddies. Hey, buddy. Now, there are actually, and I think these are the two that you could have. Oh. Oh, hey! What I was going to say was, before I was so fucking rudely interrupted, game, is that I'm pretty sure the Allosaurus and the Carnotaurus, which were those two dinosaurs, I'm pretty sure those two actually can go in the same enclosure. I did that in one game, which is a mesas sort of map. We'll get there. We'll show you that one later. And it went very poorly. That was actually also where I learned about how you just don't want to put fucking shitty dinosaurs together, because I was like, oh my God, I am bleeding cash healing these idiots fighting each other. So let's take a break. I'm going to take a break. Go refill your coffees and your bevies and such, because this is almost the perfect time. And then we'll come back and we'll do the next mission. Hang tight. Break time. All right, let's get back into this shit kicker. Woo-hoo. This game's awesome. Love the
We'd worked vignettes. To make sure the dinosaurs would thrive in the forest. At first, I believed this was for the best. Then we realized that forest makes up about 1/5 of the total land mass in the U.S. and almost 40% of Canada's wilderness.
Yeah.
Working together with the DFW and the CIA, we made the dinosaurs feel right at home. In the forest.
Oops.
I really hope the powers that be know what they're doing. Because the dinosaurs definitely do.
Time to go to Pennsylvania.
The only way to fly, right? Private. Away from the hubbub of the public. No prying eyes asking wordless questions I don't feel much like answering. Now, call me crazy. You wouldn't be the first. But we need to centralize our operations, and that's why I've chosen this location. Well, okay, I didn't choose it myself, but I was part of the process. I mean, I got the memo. The Appalachians have long been a place where people can kind of disappear, whether on their own or with the help of someone else. So, why not the dinosaurs?
Why not? That's a great question, my dude.
Pull
I'll tell
a
you
few
when I
strings,
answer.
Grease a few palms, twist a few arms, and bang! Just like that, the Department of Fish and Wildlife has a new base of operations. Now, we'll need to hit the ground running if we're going to have this place ready for something it hasn't dealt with in 65 million years. The bare bones are established. But before the ones covered in flesh and blood arrive, we'll need it fully functioning. Owen and Claire are already on site. They'll have more info for you. Dr. Dua will be coordinating your activities. And me? I'll be managing expectations and staying an arm's length away from the meat of sources.
Oh, good.
Oh, wait. Arm's length is probably not the best choice of words.
We may need some additional hands on this one. Mr. Lambert?
Standing by and ready to go. Just give the word.
George Lambert is an expert ranger who worked with us in the islands and is now with the DFW. He and Owen will deal with the dinosaurs, while we address the facilities.
There are a number of animals from your previous captures that will be coming your way soon. Delays are unacceptable.
Understood. We'll start with the construction of animal enclosures.
We'll catch them, you keep them.
Okay, I like this plan. Start by removing some of these excess path spaces here. Now, what is our map like? Oh yes, this is like right in the middle. So let's sort of pick a direction. I guess we'll use this area right here. It's gonna pick a space. I guess I didn't need to delete all that, but that wasn't even the one I wanted here. This is the one I'm looking for. I'm gonna start with a gate. There is some funny things actually in the game where the grid snapping can be sort of different than what the starting buildings are. And so if you want to move the starting buildings, you can, which is actually kind of nice, but it is a little expensive. But if you really, you're like, no, fuck, I need to move these. It doesn't work for me. Totally an option. And that is actually, it's quite nice, actually. So just sort of thinking about, okay, so we got the response facility, we got the control center, this is the arrival point, and our generator. Let's go into this space, this middle area, and then we'll do a third and a fourth, I think. Yeah, let's do that. Okay, so we'll start with just a couple of lengths of the old dirt trail here. What is it, just a regular facility path? Yeah, okay. Woo, there you go. That should be more than enough, and we'll just sort of draw it up this way. Now, the more space, like this, as in the same as any city building or, sandbox construction game, as you add infrastructure, you will also need to add in services. And so the reason I'm making this so big is because we're going to have the four paddocks, and I'll use these guys to just sort of help determine how far out they'll be. I'll just start with this one about there. That should be good. We'll just path it in. Weeping. There we go. And we'll throw the fences down as well, because she said we're going to be getting all of our old species. I wonder if they're going to give us all the names of them too. It'd be fun. Bolts are snapping straight. See, we're getting to the edge of the thing here, so I'm just gonna north or west or whatever direction it is. I don't know. Ooh, nice, nice, solid, solid curve there. Solid. There we go. And build that up. And around a nice, woo, yeah. Okay, we'll just stop that for a sec and we'll come back to this side. We know we gotta go to the edge of this one here. We're gonna have a few species in here. I don't think we're gonna have like visitors or whatever. So I think it's just the park. The Department of Forestry or whatever the hell it is, staff again. So I don't think we have to worry about too much like it being aesthetically pleasing on this. Oh, wow. You just can't fucking do it, can you, man? Just the hardest thing. Draw a straight line with a straight line tool. Woo! That was a heck of a curve. Not really getting fancy on this here. It doesn't really matter. Where's that other one? What's up over there? Okay. Yeah, there you go. There we go. There we go. And click done. Okay. So let's segment this off. We've got one here. Let's go about, say, right there. Why not? Good enough for the girls I go with. Kind of there. Yeah, that will fuck. Let's bring it in. And snappy diddy snap. Great. And then we'll do another one sort of about there. Really awesome fence line on that one. Super crooked. And you know what? We'll use this actually as a larger double space. And then that way we can stuff a couple of dinosaurs in there. Now, if you want to, like I was saying, if you want to make sure your areas are really awesome for them, you can remove the terrain at great expense. But it is sometimes worth it because you're like, oh, wow, look at that. I just burned fucking $250,000, $150,000 just removing trees, right? So sometimes it's good, sometimes it's not. It just depends on what you're doing, how you're playing, and what sort of aesthetic you're going for in your areas. Let's get this one set up. Yeah, no, other way. Jimmy, there you go. And we need one here. There is actually a funny component as well. There are some mechanics that are required just to make your park operational. Of course, the arrival point, you need to have your park open. You need to have a dinosaur. And you need to have somewhere for people to look at it. And if you don't have sort of those three of the tripod, it doesn't matter what you've done elsewise or what kind of animal is in the park. If they can't see it, walking past on a path isn't good enough. And it'll just flounder. We didn't put gates on this, did we? No, this is our response facility here. So I'm going to put a gate like right there, and then we'll just do them on this side and this side. And then that way we don't have a lot of excessive in-out traffic here as well. And that should be more than enough to start. So the Carnotaurus is going to be coming in. He's a Metasaurus. I'm going to put him in the middle here. So let's get a little water feature in there. A little water. And we'll put that in there. Well, we know we cleared out this area actually here, so throw that in there. Transport Dinosaur. There we go. You go there, and you go there. Not enough fences down.
We have new arrivals that will need food and housing.
I'd also suggest keeping a close eye on these dinosaurs.
Yeah, we are. Until we're going to send the fucking dinosaur trampers. Trampers.
They've had a taste
trappers.
Of the wild. Confinement may not sit well with them.
Okay.
To go trank them immediately.
We make no assumptions and pay attention to all the details.
Good. Remember, just like us, the dinosaurs are always learning.
And you need to keep that in mind as you build another dinosaur habitat. Safety first, for them and us.
Yeah.
Get it built. Then get the dinosaurs into the new enclosure. That about cover it, Doc?
Perfectly.
Perfectly. Very good. Happy team. Okay, we'll throw one down there. We'll throw one of these in sort of over here. You can see it doesn't quite fill the space, but that's okay. It just has to be close enough on this one. This one's actually pretty close. If I go there, there we are. And then we'll add those ranger teams as well. Capture team goes for sure to the carnivore. And we'll wait on the other one so we just don't fill it. Oh, the other ranger team, that's right. And he can do that one first, because there's nothing there to check. He'll drive out there and find nothing. Nothing going, so. Now we need to make sure they're happy, but I tranked them immediately. Sleepy time. Oh, they didn't keep the names. They didn't keep, well, we know who they are. We know who you are. Yeah, we remember. We remember. There we are. All right, now we're gonna. Oh, there's our. I was gonna say we'll get our ranger team over there. There we go. What are you missing? Prey, and that's it. And then you're just basic. Oh no, you need all kinds of shit. All right, let's get you going here. So he's not happy probably because he hasn't done any exploring, but we'll just kind of make that a little just like that. There we go. Needs some sandy spaces. There's some nice sand. Dump it right underneath him. Just pack it in around him. Right? Right? He won't notice. He won't care. It's making him happy. How about this one? Happy dinosaurs. Just dump the sand on him. Let them roll in it. They'll revel around. There we are. Add a big chunk there. Right next to the water. Under the ranger station a little. Maybe up to that path space, right? Now they need some goats to eat. Some happy goats. You'll notice there's the little icon here, the diamond in the bottom corner, sort of indicating which items are the preferred options for those dinosaurs. Not all of them are equal. Some of them, some of them are better, some of them are worse. We'll put a prey feeder there, we'll put another one over here. And that way we've got a couple in there. And that should be more than enough for these guys. They're still sleepy. How much longer are they gonna be snoozing for? 4.5 minutes. So yeah, we're gonna just wake them up. Wakey, wakey.
Collecting asset. Picking up asset.
Time to get up, boys. Where's the bugle call? Watch, that's actually like a cavalry charge or something. Speed that up just a little bit there. And then you'll see the notices that it's got to be viewable from a viewing gallery. But we do have that in and it shouldn't be an issue. We could probably actually cut this like right down here and it'd be actually sizable enough. Some of the spaces for these required are actually quite small, but I don't know. It seems
asset
wrong.
Delivered.
And then on your galleries, you'll see it actually said right here, visible dinosaurs. And each one has a dinosaur appeal. This rating is directly tied to the dinosaur itself. And so on the info tab, it'll actually show you all kinds of cool stuff in here. Their attack, defense, yes, you can modify these values a little bit. Their infamy, because of its winning fights and killing people and all that stuff. The lifespan. And then finally, I believe it's actually on that, right there, the appeal. And so the more of these you have, the higher the appeal will be for that viewing gallery, right? Makes sense. So it is a way to actually, to game the system. Is to have dinosaurs with high appeal. Now I'm going to show you something really quick, so maybe I'm not. What am I looking for here? This is the one. Sorry. There are a ton of different types of animals that you can get into as you unlock them. See, some of them I haven't, but as you unlock them, they'll actually give you options. Now, specifically, I'm looking for hang on. Let me just finish the Oka. Not that one. It's the not that one. No, hang on. This guy right here. I'm pretty sure. The Tylosaurus or whatever the hell it is. It's like 3,000 rating. So if you put one of these in, people just lose their shit. So basically, as soon as you want to win any of your matches, you just build one of these. It is expensive. A couple $1,000,000 to get it all in. And I mean like 10. But it's basically like a win ticket. Punch it and you just win the game. Well, the Allosaurus. Wait, we were gonna put him. You know what? Let's actually carve this one into two. I think it's pretty large. Let's do that real quick. Right there. That's gonna give it that. Same, I want you to have it from a viewing gallery thing. There you go. And we'll add in the little gate guy about right, yeah, there, just to make it easy. And we'll throw another one in over here. And we should have hopefully enough room. Maybe I left enough room. Yeah, lots of room there. Okay, lots of room for a thing here. We'll get up. Whoop. And we'll just kind of sort of there. I'm just eyeballing it. It's not really, like I said, it's not really super important. And then we can throw that viewing gallery in right over here. And make sure we have visible dinosaurs. The nice thing is, like I was saying with this pathing system is here, let me take that out. And let's just sort of prettify this one a little bit here. So we've got sort of a blind just behind the tree there, but that's okay. So we've got this path here. I'm just going to kind of bring it up to the edge of the building here. Just sort of eye measuring here with the steady line. And I'm going to bring it up and you see it automatically snaps. I'm going to hit left shift and then it brings the curve feature in. And that's kind of nice. I'll let that build up. Do we have enough electricity actually being pumped out right now? You can check if you click. So our fuel's at 33, but the power usage is 13 out of 30. We've got 4 minutes of usage on that. So we'll juice it up a little bit. I could probably crank it up all the way, but whatever. Now, the Allosaur is also going to need some chow. So let's throw him in this one. And we'll give you a dude. Oh, hey, you know what? I'll move that. Sorry, Mr. Ranger. He's like, dude, I'm
paid enough for this shit, man. Moving the ranger posts all the time. Who's running this shitstorm?
Welcome to Jurassic Park. Spared no expense. Lost everything several times. Tried again.
Yeah, okay. Just make sure we got it. Oh, we were looking for the goats. Need the baby goats. Oh, yes, yes. Bring me an Alamosaurus.
Asset transportation underway.
And I will give it goats.
I'm not sure I'll ever be fully comfortable at the park, but the lab coats want to make sure the dinosaurs are, so that's a job you should stay on top of.
There we go. The lab coats.
Asset transportation complete.
And visible dinosaurs one, so that's good. Now we just gotta make sure it's happy. What do we call this? Oh, he's gonna eat the ranger. Oh, he's gonna eat the ranger. Jesus, hang on. You wanna see what terrifying looks like? Here we go. Direct control. No, I'm not gonna fucking play with that game. That dinosaur gonna eat him. All right, he's missing some water, only because he just hasn't seen it yet. We can see the lake over there, obviously. So as soon as he expands his territory, which is what this value is, that's what this image highlight is his territory. There you go. See, he thinks it's perfect. I knew he would. Now we'll just get that spin up. Well, there we go. Get that spin up so he can just be clicked in. Now, if you want to do, there's a couple of quick views. So you can hit the M key, and you can see like a tactical map
the
of your park.
The dinosaurs seem to be taking to their new surroundings.
Who's liking what?
I want
territory.
To make sure they are doing more than surviving. However, we need the animals thriving. As I'm sure you understand, our research is more valuable when we have superior specimens in their optimal conditions. So I want you to get a science center built
Sounds
and
like
operational.
A new Genesis.
This means more scientists will be needed. So build a staff center as well. Ultimately, science is about the data we collect and analyze. Rubbish in, rubbish out. We want to avoid that at all costs, especially when you consider the investment that has already been made in these dinosaurs. The CIA wants results, and we're going to get them. Period. Full stop. End of story.
Period. Full stop. End of story. All right. Like her attitude. Fucking go-getter kind of lady. Okay, so you'll see this yellow line. That's your power tether. It'll tell you if that building is going to be powered by which building, as it were. In this case, it's the generator station. We don't actually have, I believe, we don't have a proper power plant. No, we don't. So we'll have to continue riding on those stupid things. So for those kinds of situations, obviously, keep everything as tight as you can. Oh, that actually, I think it was going to fit. Yeah, it was. Look at that. Fucking eye. So we'll just that right in there. And then that way you don't have to build multiple generators to keep track of. It's kind of annoying. Let's add in the staff center. And what is the other one? The paleomedical. Okay. Staff centers allow you to hire more scientists. And they also give different benefits. So on, say, like your science center, you can click over here. And there's upgrades. And they provide different things. Storm defense is so clutch on a couple of different maps for the achievements and stuff. But otherwise, extraction is what you're really going to want to go for. The game, the monetary system, let me just pause this for one sec. The money system in the game, if you were to say like right now we've got the $3.6 million, okay? But let's say that this upgrade, just as an example, cost us $5 million, okay, for the fossil storage. It's a $5 million upgrade that's going to put us 1.4 in the hole. If you don't come into the black by the end of the game year, you fail. You don't get a chance. There's no loans. There's no, you know, whatever. So if you make a purchase like that, or if you got to, you know, pay for something bad, be prepared. Or if a storm comes and wrecks half your park, or a dinosaur gets around, or whatever, that can really kick you in the fucking junk. So be aware. Oh yeah, this is a kind of a nice thing. If you see I tried to make it happen here. The sun is sort of glinting off of this, but there's a lens flaring. Oh, there it is. There's a lens flaring effect that the camera function has in the game, which is quite nice. Beautiful lighting in this. Well done. Let's get that paleo medical down. So we'll throw this way. And just kind of, yeah, right next to the staff center. They're trying to sleep. Fucking medical vans coming and going, treating dinosaurs with diarrhea. They're wailing. Their shit stinks everywhere. They eat raw meat, you know.
Lambert here. We could really use an expedition center. Get one built.
Okay, Lambert. I'll get one built. You know, it'd be nice like that other lady. That's not pairing in for the wonderful reasons that it does. There we go. Snap. Delete and just square up. I want to get a expedition center. No. Yep. So many helicopters. There's one sort of downside in some of the buildings. Like you see these ones, they didn't really snap to the grid very well. But the t-shirt shops and shit like that, they will.
Okay, Dr. Dua and that guy Finch must be getting pressure from above because they want more animals rounded up. Check the expedition map and dispatch a remote capture team to a hotspot. I'll do what I can on my end.
All right. Select a scientist to oversee a live capture expedition. To go get it. Where are we? St. Louis. All right. I'm going to save my cheaper research person, and we're just going to send the generalist. Points and everything. Way you go. Now, it did also give us an opportunity when
okay,
we built the staff
the good
center
news
to get
first.
New scientists.
We've
so
been
we
achieving some success with our remote capture teams, which here. Means a steady supply of dinosaurs to our control center. Now, that I like. Removing them from possible uncontrolled interaction with the general public is a 100% win in my book. Now to the bad news, which I always hate getting, but honestly, kind of enjoy giving. These animals are arriving with an unknown disease, and we've got to get a handle on it post-haste. That's nice. Management speak for PDQ, huh? Pretty damn quick. Dr. Dua?
We can diagnose this disease with scans from our mobile veterinary unit. We'll get it under control before too long.
That's good. Let's get to work.
Oh. I ran out of gas. It went full fucking Jurassic Park. Now you notice none of the dinosaurs are like freaked out yet. Oh yeah, let's just add more. The fucking nightmare is hot and ready. Transport dinosaur. All right, let's do it. Let's throw you guys in over here. That was the, yeah, let's put them here. There we go. Okay, now let's get it some gas. Because man, living on the edge here. Sounds like a really good song we've written, like the title like that, hey? There we go. So now it's got gas, the lights come back on, the fences are electrified again, and we live another day. Do we get a ranger team here? Yeah, we do. Okay, so we've got a ranger post there. So he'll come scooting. Yeah, see, here he is. Scooting on over already. Here, you know what? Let's name the ranger team. Your name now, it's not Ranger Team 1, it's Scooty. It's not Scotty, it's Scooty. This is sort of like Tapor Rouge. Flaming Rouge. There we go. Now these guys are probably gonna need some chow. Do you eat that stuff? Is that the kind of chow you like? Where's the Rangers at? He's fighting. Oh, he's eating another dinosaur. You crazy things. There he is. Scooty! Scooty! Come check the ankylosaurums. Make sure that they are okay. Do we we have names for the eggs? I don't think we did. Oh, I know what we should call it. Oh, you can't put a hyphen in, apparently. But there you go. There we go. Beavis and Butthead. Oh, and he's apparently needing a dock. Okay, let's get the T for the team of medics at a task. You go scan Beavis and Butthead. Go check, see what's up with those two fucking yokels. Meanwhile, Scooty's going to visit the terrifying Allosaurus. He's a brave man, Scooty. Stupid, you know. I mean, I don't know why he took this job. I'd feel that you could kind of, because it's a little bit stupid taking this job, I'm not gonna lie. This has ground fiber and fruit. He needs leaves. He needs leaves. So we're gonna look for fruit and leaf. That's leaf. I guess it's just the one, so.
You have to understand something. Owen and I signed on to this project because we want what is best for the dinosaurs. Not for them to be exploited or engineered, hacked and spliced and compromised.
They deserve a chance at life as much as any other living creature.
Honestly, perhaps even more, as the miracle of science gave them a second chance.
So, do the research, find the cure, and then let's use it. Or the dinosaurs die. Again. And listen, that's not going to happen.
Well, I mean, Owen, they're not immortal, my dude. But regardless, welcome to the research screen. The crux of this is pretty obvious. It's the same as in any other game. There's things in here that you can unlock over time. If you want to play the sandbox mode of this game, you do need to play the campaign versions to unlock the elements in sandbox. So if you want a power plant in sandbox, you need to play the game and unlock the power plant in the game first. And that's why we've gone through the motions of sort of showing how this all kind of collects together. So which one are we supposed to be looking for here? Fucking tuberculosis? What do we need? What do we need? Cryptosporidiasis. I think I actually only even said that right. But there is a much bigger tech tree, obviously, than just what we're seeing here. Cryptosporidiosis. Okay. Yeah. It's a fungal infection of the butt. We're going to take our cheaper research. You'll see here it added a 30% reduction. And so it's now 70 grand. Before it would have been 100. So that's nice. And then a little bit of time bonus as well because we put our person on it. Now, there is also a limit of people you can have for the tasks. Some are one, some are two, some are three, some are more. And so we can't add this guy. No room. So, silly. So we'll send him off. This we don't have enough people for. What's the other thing that wanted us to research here? What's this? Oh, the scientists training and the efficiency upgrades. Yeah, okay. Well, we'll come back to those. We'll come back to those. All right, so let's let our people do the research here. You can see it's just ticking down the timer. Have a little puff of this here, doobie stick. Nice, calm, relaxing moment before all the dinosaurs get sick, start vomiting everywhere. The smell here would just be repulsive. So there we go. Now we've got our research. So we'll get our medivan, and we'll let him go start juicing up all the dinos. You can see we got five, and our fuel, of course, everybody needs to run on gas around here. It's gonna fill him up all the way, and keep going. And see, he's gonna run around. This is kind of amusing. He just runs around and literally just shows up. He either hits him with a tricorder, or pumps him full of fucking darts and just like, here, have your medicine. So now what it's given us here is another thing to research, which is the inoculation. Sometimes you gotta research them, sometimes it's free. But as you can see, it prevents all future cases of cryptosporidiasis from occurring. And how you get those is sometimes you just gotta medicate them, sometimes you gotta take a picture of them, other times you just gotta research something and it'll click over and away you go. Wait, why do we lose power? Are we out of gas again? Oh my god. We are burning through the fuel here. All right, let's fill it right up. How many minutes is that going to give us? 26. That's not a lot of time. All right. This place is going to be expensive for that. We still have another one that's sick? Seriously? Where? Oh, no. Okay. We just hadn't tranked him yet. Good. Good job, team. Complete the DFW headquarters by increasing asset rating. So that means we need to find dinos.
Dr. Dua, this is Lambert. I've just received word that you'd like us to increase our capture efforts. Can you confirm?
Yes, that's correct. We need to grow this facility, which means we need more animals. It's time to stress test our systems and make sure we're capable of managing both the science and our operations.
Maybe.
Understood. My teams are standing by. We still have a number of dinosaurs in the wild. Plenty of targets to bring in.
Assets. And yes, this will be an ongoing mission for us moving forward.
Yeah, like I said, the fuel thing in the game is kind of greasy, but it is also an encouragement to use backup generators as backup generators. It's not a fuel source, as it were, right? So let's go to our expedition map. Had to get a new power thing for my DB stick. So this is one way that the game shows how to get dinosaurs. This is the live capture, and they're noted by these exclamation points. When you do the fossil researches, they've got just a different, like a dig hammer, a pickaxe, and then that way you can identify the two very easily. These don't usually show up as much in the other game mode unless you sandbox and select it, but otherwise this is it. So a Sinoceratops, Parasaurolophus, a Deinonychus, what do we got here? Baryonyx, broadside, Diplodocus. That could be kind of fun. Torosaurus, Chasmosaurus. A Brachiosaurus? I think those are all of them. I'm just gonna... Woo! There is a whole world to check out. And yeah, apparently there's like a hidden Antarctica one, though. I don't know how to unlock that, but yeah. Let's do the Diplodocus. Those big mama jammas. Big mama jammas. What do we need for this one? We need 6. So let's send the Generalist and the Altruist, because if we need to research something, we'll still have him standing by. Send those two. And there you go. You can see you can only do one at a time. He's sent off. The helicopter fucks off. And you'll have 2.5 minutes to complete a space for a Diplodocus, which I think we'll use this one for. Nice and big space. They usually... Big dinosaur, big space. So I think this one will work really nice for that. Let's add in just a wee bit of water. The nice thing, too, is that the jeeps can drive all the way through the water. When you make water in the game, it's not like you're trenching a lake or anything like that. It's just little like slough pond thing. So visually it's like, oh yeah, it's totally deep, but no, it's a fucking puddle. I'm sure you could probably like make lower terrain, I guess, maybe, and fill it with water, but an Icyclosaurus. Ooh, that'd be fun. Oh, somebody sounds angry. Didn't you get your morning goat, Spock? Spock is content. So there's our Diplodocus. Oh, 2 captured, 1 evaded. How did it evade? Even I got the thing in the fucking woods eventually. Like, man. Imagine how fast that guy was. Right? Just flying through the woods. Diplododge this. Oh, apparently I haven't unlocked those, so that's one more for the sticker book. 63 out of 79. Got drunk stormtroopers manning the dart guns again. 100% possible.
Asset has been delivered.
So there we go.
Delivery complete.
Diplodocus is 1 and 2. But they need names. You need a way better name than Diplodocus. Wow. You know what he reminds me of? Is that thing from, shit, what was the puppet movie? I'm going blank now. It had the little fuzzy dog in it. And the weird mouse people. The Dark Crystal. I don't remember the name of the other guys, but it reminded me of that. The face of that thing. Huh? Right? Right? You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? All right. Do we have a ranger on there? Yes, we do, but it looks like he's having issues. What's your problem? Oh, you're like half dead. Scooty's in danger.
Run, Scooty! Run! Oh, we never named the Allosaurus either. You know what? We're gonna name you. Longtime supporter of the show. Big fan. Thanks, buddy. Laurel and Hardy. Oh my god. Why are we naming these Laurel and Hardy? This feel I don't know this. I'm just naming them Laurel and Hardy. You're gonna be like, oh, it's the thing. I'm like, oh yeah, okay. There we go. Laurel and Hardy. And our Allosaurus named Ken. Spock and Kirk. We named the, yeah, Beavis and Butthead. That's right. Comedy duo in the same era as Three Stooges. Oh, okay. Oh, I am vaguely familiar. Find a funny and post it in the Discord. I'm pretty sure, actually, if I'm not mistaken, I'm pretty sure these things are actually working. Let me just... Hey, look at that. Good. Okay. Making sure that actually did work. All right. Oh, and we've got, okay, so we've got 1600. We need a couple more dinos. Now, wait, why are you a threat? Did we not get a status check on this thing yet? He's probably hungry. He's going to go rampaging through the shit here. Or I say he, but it's she. It's Laurel. Laurel's going to freak out. Tail whip one of those fucking ranger things. Yeah, okay. I know. Oh, I see. They're both men. Okay. That makes more sense now, I guess, given the time error, right? So he's missing tall fruit. Tall fruit, hey. How's the area? The area is an excellent size for them. Cohabitation has no issues. There's no other dinosaurs in there. So let's just find some chow for him. Tall leaf, 2 on the fruit. This one has a 3. So let's add that in. How much forest? Forest is okay. So we don't want to take too many trees away. And the open space is excellent. So we could actually fill in some of that, you see. And then we're not taking anything away. We're only giving him more stuff to chow on. Some more yummies to eat and make for delicious living spaces for our dinosaurs. Abbott and Costello. I like that. So we'll just give this a second here. I think Hardy is a little bit freaking out here, but he should be a little better now that we got some of the space good for him. There we go. Yeah, that's looking nice. Okay. So do we have any empty spaces at the moment? No. We've got all of these are now filled with dinosaurs. Can we do any cohabitation? Let's have a look. Which one is it? This one, I never remember. This one, there we go. See, he actually likes ankylosaurs. Hmm. So you know what we could do? Pick those motherfuckers up and throw them on over here. And we may actually just do that. What are the ankylosaurs and what do these guys eat? He needs tall fruit. And I think the Anks needed low and other stuff, didn't they? So that may not actually fly too well. Where's Butthead? Yeah, he needed ground fruits. You know what? We'll actually leave that as it is. We'll leave that as it is. I think we can actually cut the Carnotaurus area down in size, but whatever. We'll leave that. It's not a big deal. Is there a broken fence or something somewhere? Not enough power? Is it it's damaged. I see. Let's get Scooty. Add task. Come here, buddy. Fix that up. The dinosaurs have been acting all crazy. All right, let's make a new space for the next group here, which as we're aiming right now, will be Abbott and Costello. I like that. throw that about there. Give it a Jiminy Jilliker. Perfect. Let's add in an additional. No, we're still only at 20. That'll be okay. What? No power on that? No kidding. You don't say, hey. Son of a firearm. There we are. There we go. Nice, beautiful. Fucking rainstorm in the middle of this. Yeah. Wait. Do you remember Jurassic Park the movie? Remember that? And the island, Isla Nublar, and they were beset by a tropical storm. I turn the Pennsylvania camera to a tornado. Yeah. They're all gone. Oh yeah, shit, I forgot one thing. Better open the emergency shelters. Oh, I don't have any. Wonder who's gonna live through this. Let's see what happens. Yeah, that's a problem. A building has been damaged by the storm. Seems legit. So, good. Good. I'm just gonna unassign these real quick, just so I can get a couple of extra tasks out of Scooty here before he goes. I'm gonna repair the science center for 200 grand. The staff center for 40. Our viewing galleries and our fences. And we're gonna hope that Scooty's as fast as his name implies. Get on it, buddy. Oh, actually, you know what I'm gonna do here? Let me show you this really quick. So you can see I've got shit going all over, but there he is right there. I got two tasks he could complete really easy. So I'm actually just gonna leave that screen really quick. Go back to Scooty, and you can see all the tasks here. Shit, hang on, I don't think I did it right. No, it didn't. It's not doing it. Hang on. Do I need this facility? There's a little gimme jimmy trick it to doing it here, and it's just not showing it up for some reason. Oh yeah, sorry, no, I'm just not doing it correctly. There we go. So yeah, so you come down to the option, you click on it, and then it'll give you a choice to actually move that up or down in position in priority. So you can see we're gonna make that now top priority, and then we're gonna do this one as well, the viewing gallery, same thing, double to the top. And then he's gonna do these two and bugger off. Yeah, I just wanted to show you that feature, as I just sort of saw, I kind of did them all out of order, didn't really know where he was. I thought he was at the base, to be honest, but yeah, there you go. And then you can see he's gonna do the fence repair, he's gonna do this, no way he goes. And he just drove right through the fence he fixed, because Scooty is that fast. And see, then away he goes doing the other things too. And then we will add back his patrol team options. So yay, A, B, C, and D.
Ah, General Kenobi.
Good to see you, Sheppy. How you doing? How you doing, buddy? We're making a new dinosaur space here. We sort of half did it, and then a tornado came. Like, actually. Not mine, in the game, because, Jurassic Park. Wouldn't be fun if a fucking tornado didn't show up and try and wreck your Pennsylvania wilderness adventurum park, reserve, dinosaur habitat. I don't even know what the hell this thing is. Because it's the Department of Fish and Wildlife, so I don't know what the hell that makes it. Nice little space there for our whatever the hell we're bringing in. We were so concerned with whether or not we could, we forgot to ask ourselves whether or not we should. Right? Such a great film. Let's add that door. This is the response facility. Where is it? It's over here. Oh, no, that's that. It's this one here. Okay, let's add it right there. Right in behind the guy. Just drive straight out of the building into it. Did we actually get another expedition going? I don't think we started one yet. Let's do one now. What do we got? Oh, baryonyx. Let's grab a couple of these guys. Do we have the fishy feeder? We must. I'm sure we do. So you'll see this value here is increasing the unrest. If you get it up to the top and it turns red, your scientists start getting all pissed off and they do really stupid things. And then eventually there's this little, it's hard to see, but right down here, I'm trying to flash it. There's a meter that will fill up as you do bad things. And the more bad things you do, the more likely bad shit's going to happen. The more Dennis Nedry essentially is unlocked. Now we do is just give our research team a second here, and go collect that pair of baryonyxes. Now I know that they're gonna want some fishy areas, so let's get our waters here. I'm gonna just some trees out. And there goes a couple of fucking 100 grand, and we'll throw in some water. What a beautiful pond. Make a flying murder dinosaur, put it in a place that's not an aviation cage. I haven't done that yet. Because I'm not really sure how to be honest. Oh, one captured, one evaded. What was the name of it? Broadside. That's right. That's who we got here. We got ourselves broadside.
Asset transportation in progress.
Bring him on over. Let's add in some food for old Broadside. We know he likes eating the fishies. Could also probably call him Captain Eyeliner. He only needs two.
Transportation.
There we go. Welcome to the show, Broadside. Are we out of gas again? Oh my god. Oh my god, game. Wait, did I just fucking... Oh, okay, no, it's just being that. Okay, hang on. There goes another half million. Ding. Gone. And juice the park. Jesus. How much is this thing running? 23. Okay, so that enclosure took 3 power. All right. What do we need for a value? 22 out of 3. Need more. Let's have a look at our expedition map. What else we got in here? Sinoceratops. Pterosaural office. Deinonychus. A Brachiosaurus. Chasmosaurus and a Torosaurus. There's 5 of those near the Killington Ski Resort. Jesus, that sounds terrifying. In Utica. Scranton. Oh, Sheppy, you have no idea, buddy. Like, the Jennies run out real fast. The gas is a half million a fill. In this right now, I don't have power plants. Power plants you can eventually unlock. They're essentially like nuclear plants or whatever. But those are way, way, way more efficient than the gas Jennies. Let's do this one. Let's get the Scranton Brachiosaurus, and he will need a single... obviously, office name reference. Now, you see, this one needs 3 in logistics and in science, so we're going to take these 2 guys because they're good for that. Set them off. They run on Saffron. They do. And, I mean, they're just mad about it. Mad about Saffron. We're going to need a space for that guy. Let's throw it over here. I'll pause this while that helicopter's fucked off because, you know, this is how the real world, it totally works this way. You know, you're just like, oh, I've sent a thing off to go happen. And he's like, cool, how long is it going to take you? 10 minutes. I'll be back in 10 minutes. No problem. Can you build a dinosaur enclosure in 10 minutes? I can. How are you going to do it? Well, you see, I actually moonlight as Kronos, god of time. And I have a little watch, so I just give it a little wibbly gibbet and away I go. And then, you know, no problem. There, that's a nice, nice large enclosure for a nice large dinosaur. Although we only have 1 of them. So... you know what? Yeah, let's cut it in half again. Sure, why not? Fucking A. Let's do it right down here. Bing, bing. Yeah, let's get a little whoop. Nice. Nice. $1,500. Wow. Might be cheaper than your current fuel, to be honest. You guys want to hear a funny story about gas and drugs? Yeah, you do. You always want to hear a fucking great story about that. There was a grow-op that was happening in BC. There were so many grow-ups in BC before legalization. And what had happened on this one particular is it was in an isolated area in some of the more mountainous areas in the lower central area. And very isolated logging kind of space. So nobody goes there. But they couldn't figure it out, the logging company. There was a couple of guys that were working there. And they couldn't figure out why there was every week a fuel truck would drive up the top of the mountain and would just sit there. And then the next week it would drive down and a new one would go up every single week. And these are those full tanker truck things, right? And so eventually they called the police because they're like, it's weird. I don't know what's happening, but maybe they're dumping something. That's what they thought. Well, they were. They were dumping gas into the generators that were running all the lights and the fans and the da 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 because they had actually buried in the mountain several sea cans, rail cars. There was, I think, like 10 of them, 12 of them. And so they had an actual underground grow-op happening. And that wasn't the only one. There were dozens of these things happening. And so if you're ever wondering why legalization happened in Canada, that's why. That's one of the biggest reasons. But yeah. Fucking sea can grow up in the mountainside. Nothing suspicious there. throwing in the ranger stations. This is a teeny tiny little one here, so we'll put a little dinosaur in there, but obviously not a lot of room in there either. So let's add the ranger team. Scooty, where you at, buddy? It's running out of tasks that he can actually perform. What is this one? Who's this, Beavis? Is it Butthead? Broadside. Oh yeah, the Baryonyx. Yeah, you're gonna stand there by yourself. You're gonna stand there by yourself. There we go. Oh, it's giving me power grief because the fences are building in between areas, so we'll just have to wait for that to go away. Who's the angry dinosaur? What is your problem? Why are you a danger to guests? What is your issue? He's a danger. Why? Danger's his middle name. Is he even moving? Oh, he is. Okay. Like, is it dead? Oh, he's gonna go it. He's gonna make a break for it. He's gonna make a break for it. Maybe not. Maybe not. Oh. Danger to guests equals broken fence. Oh, is that what it is? Oh. 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 Transpired. Okay, hang on. We'll go find out where that hole is. Throw him over there. Go give him a water puddle to drink out of. Map mode. No. There's no broken fence. Or is it this maybe? Oh, yeah. You know, I think there's just no connection there. Oh, yeah. Look at that. It just didn't connect. Okay. There you go. Boom. Boom. Watch that go away. Wait for it. Wait for it. Oh, we gotta wait for a status check. Oh, he's hungry? What are you hungry for now, you stupid? Stupid. There's food everywhere. Go just pick something up and eat it.
Asset
jackass.
Transported.
That's what your name really should have been. He's content now. Very good. Okay. Now, you wrecked your fence. You had it for 2 minutes. And maybe it was broadside. What's your problem? Why are you guys all fucking... Why are you Jurassic Parking the shit out of this Jurassic Park? Honestly. Dinosaur, just stop being stupid. He's gonna go fight this thing. What are we naming this, by the way? What do we want to name this guy? It's Big Tolly. Oh, I know. Any Zim fans out there? My tallest. Let's go see if he fights him. Where is he? He's still over here. Ranger, Scooty. Oh God, I need another ranger station. Do I have another ranger vehicle? I only have the one, I think. Yeah, I only got the one vehicle. Can I get the upgrade to get the extra vehicle? Additional ranger team. No, it's gonna be a little bit before we can get that, I guess, hey? Okay, well, let's just build another one then. Let's just get another second one. Here we go, response facility, because you know, I have one when you can have two twice the price, right, Carl? Right. Okay, let's throw it over here. Where's the edge of the map? Over there. Yeah, let's throw it in here. Yeah, this way. Okay. Boom! Perfect placement. Every time. Nailed it. There we go. We'll just, woo! Easy there, clicks. Easy there. Well, I do like this, and then we'll just delete that, and then it'll it's a nice little space here to link up to. There. Perfection. Absolute and utter perfection. The first one lets you have 4 vehicles per station. That, it seems, actually a really good quantity. That feels good. South Park Stick of Truth. Is that any good? A buddy of mine years ago played that when it first came out. He was a big South Park fan. Let me show you this. It's actually a really neat feature of the game as well. Kind of a fun one. So the pathing tool in this one, it didn't quite reach last time, but now if you want to, you can actually just go right over top of it and it will actually properly intersect. What is kind of amusing though, is you'll see that it actually still has left that in that way. Other games will be like, no, you need to draw that at the intersect, but this won't. It doesn't do that. So that's kind of a neat little feature, I think. Bit too much toilet humor for you, but some of the humor was okay. You know what? That, and that's, I can respect that. I mean, it's all in with those guys, right? One sec. All right. Anyway, sorry. I had to sneeze. Let me get another Jenny out here. We can start transferring some of the power usage over. Fire. There we go. All right. Get our next ranger station so we go do some status checks on these dinosaurs. All right, where are you? Ranger team 2. Add task. Go check him and do this and then fix the fence because, you know, Knuckle Tits here is... Look at it, breaking it again. I'm gonna hit you. What is your problem? You know what? Fuck. I'm gonna trank his ass. Where is he? Where's the trank dude? Where's the trank dude? Trank dude. Trank dude. Trank dude? Come here. Come here. Shoot him. Shoot him. Actually, here. Let me move him. Trank and move. Get over here. Get out of that shit. Asshole dinosaur. Just an asshole dinosaur. Instead of broadside, he should just be named asshole. I agree. Where is he?
Transit has commenced.
I had to go AFK during a moment in the game that got you an achievement for lingering on a specific scene for over 60 seconds. The achievement is named Pervert. That's the most amazing thing ever. So good. Just reeks of those guys. Was it Parker and Stone? Oh, so gross. All right, repair again the fence because this asshole is apparently having problems. Nope, not that. This asshole. What is his deal? What's your problem? He's like, I'm lonely. That's probably what it is. Actually, I bet you that's what it is. You know what? We might have to go and kill him. Oh, we got a thing. We got to treat a dinosaur. He's sick. Where is that? What was it? Who is it? Who's sick? Who's got the sniffles in this place? Woo! I hope you're not getting sick on the camera movements there. I have to spin those down. What? Really? Didn't it? Oh, maybe you're not allowed to add that because it's profanity. Oh, no. There we go. I just didn't hit enter, apparently. It's difficult to stick to the asshole. Wait, is he on the wrong side of the fence? Oh shit, I think he is. He is too. God damn it. Fucking dinosaurs. You know, if it's not one, it's the next. All right, Rangers. Come on. Go trank. Well, actually, I'll just tranquilize him, and then we'll take the, and then we gotta move him to the paleomedical because he's got a broken bone. So we'll hopefully this asshole doesn't do anything to create a problem. There's the tranquilizer. He's got a laceration. Transport. Where's the meds? There we go. And we'll see. Oh yeah, see here. Here, this is the angry guy. Fine. Well, you know what? We'll do a little bit. He'll be okay for one.
En route to pick up the asset.
Asshole will eat the free meal. He probably would too. He's gonna try, I bet. Where is he? No, the helicopter's scaring him.
He's like, I hate you. You're a jerk.
Alright, do we have a ranger post in there? No, we don't. That's why he's not getting the checkup. Okay. Well, at least that makes sense. Let's put one in. Right in the water. Sorry, guys. You know how it is. He's got 5 out of 5. Let's actually remove one. Because poor Scooty's just having issues here. Which 5 do you got here? Let's take that one out. There we go. And then that way he has a chance to go and sit at base to repair when he goes back. That's why he's not actually getting this meter filled up, is he's got too many tasks. So every time he goes back, he's got so much ground to cover, he has to just go out and do the next thing. And so that could be something that that causes you to spend money unnecessarily on Ranger vehicles. If you are, by the way, you'll notice I keep hitting the R key to open the response screen, and it'll usually go to the nearest one, so now I'm at this one. But you can cycle through the facilities themselves. Let's add you to that, and to that. And, we need some gates, of course. Yes, there's one there. Let's go one there. Oh, are there too many trees in the way? Too many trees.
It's really hard.
Asset has been transported.
There we go. Didn't actually check to see if he was actually happy. Oh, he's doing a status check yet. We'll see where he is. He's probably all pissed off.
I don't like this place. I'm lonely.
Oh, he's missing rocks. Oh, well. If that's all it is, hit him with one. The painting feature in this is actually kind of nice because it doesn't paint hard and fast right away. It gives a little bit of soft featuring. And let me show you here just a little bit on this grass. And you can see it just sort of softly comes in. A little Bob Rossing there for you. So it does mix the palettes a little bit. So you can have some nice color features if you want to put just like little grassy spots, you know, it like peeks through the rocks or whatever. It really allows you to get really nice and creative with that. Asshole's sitting down now. Yeah, fuck you too. Hate you. I sell you to a poacher. Turn you into a belt and chicken wings. You're gonna be a Super Bowl meal for an entire hockey team. You know, they take the kids and they go down to the sports and it's like, here is the peewee version of whatever sport we're at. What is your beef? Why can't you get in there? Oh, really? You really don't like that, hey? Assholes. Assholes everywhere. Surrounded by them. Surrounded. It's a waterbed. Right.
Oh, yeah, now it's okay. Like Jerry did it.
I guess he's done. Yeah, okay. All right, let's transport my tallest here. And back over here. We didn't actually give him any water. Let's change how this actually looks a little bit because, you know, terraforming is cheap. We're just going to rip the water out. Oh, I got the feeders in there. Fuck it, whatever. We'll just add water in because why not?
Asset has been collected.
Look at him fly. He can fly. He can fly. He can fly. He can fly. I was like, oh, he's got cool orange stripes. No, those are the belts. Okay. He's hungry. He wants to eat. Wait, what does this Brachiosaurus eat? He's a Metasaurus. Take a picture of that one. I'm pretty sure it's just the generic thing for the food, but... he needs tall nuts. Wrong game, guys. Wrong game. That's the old plants versus the zombies. But we'll add some for him anyway. Needs lots of tall nuts. And you'll see that forest value, it's not very high. He hasn't really wandered around a bit, so that's okay. We'll just add in. Doesn't need a lot of open space, but he does a little, so let's keep adding in the tall nuts. Make him happy. Get the tall nuts in there. Some in over here. Tall nuts. There we go. Is that enough? No, still not enough. Okay. Add more nuts. Needs more nuts. Oh, yeah. Just cover this place with nuts. Nuts everywhere. There you go. How much nuts? 50% nut coverage. Yeah, we could put them in the water. Free real estate. That's right. More nut coverage.
That's what she said.
There you go. I only gave you one. I mean, it had to be obvious that was coming. I mean, my God. How much nut can you put into this space before something is, you know, a miss? He's still hungry. He's looking for food. Really? You fucking blind dinosaur. Oh, man, that's got to be difficult. I tried to do that once. Didn't work out for me either. Name him Mr. Magoo. Okay, I'll get it. Yeah, Magoo. There you are. Blind dinosaur. Do we have a ranger team for him? Pretty sure we do. Yeah, we do. Okay. Santa Claus! Am I transplanting nuts from chat into game? No, God no. God no. But we could. Look at that foliage. Just having a chow. Just nom nom in the noms there. Eating some bush. Missing forest? What? Eat ass. It's like, oh, it's just a few too many nuts here.
That's what she said.
Yeah, I see it too. Alright, let's take out some nuts and add in some forest. Nope, wrong forest, sorry. There we go. Nuts for forest. More forest. Not enough open space. Love the balancing act sometimes. Okay, so let's take out just a little. What are we missing here? We got a tiny bit there. He hasn't come over here yet. So let's actually remove this. And that should be enough. All right, Jenny's. There's another $500,000 job. There is a function in the game itself and the mechanics of these modes where it'll actually just provide you. I think I can actually show you here. Let me put the money screen. Employer allowance. If we actually start running it, you see that's what that white line is. So it's the game is in this mode right now, providing me essentially free cash to keep me afloat. I'll never go bankrupt right now. It's just mostly meant to help you learn the mechanics of it all. So yeah, I know, right? No problem. But I got 9.8 sitting in the pocket here, and then yeah, I'll see it'll come back up there. Apparently I didn't let it run off. There we go. Yeah, see? 146, upkeep 33. There you go. And there's other screens that we're going to get into. There's a lot of, you know, we'll roll into those eventually. Serious? What is your fucking... Let's watch. Let's see how difficult it is. Oh, wow. That must have been hard.
That's what she said.
Sorry, I had to. Oh, such good. Who's getting snooty with Scooty? Oh, the asshole is. Nobody's surprised about that. I don't think I have to actually add in anything other than dinosaurs to just basically build park spaces. So I'm going to just crush out a couple of sites here. Where's the edge of the map? Right here. Okay. We're getting another goddamn storm. Oh, it's just rain. Burning through that dot quota at an alarming rate, right? Dude, are you? Look. I thought we had Magoo here. This is Ranger Team 2. This is fucking Lost Jerry. I don't know where the hell he's going, but every time he finds his way, apparently. Fucking idiot sticks lost. Well, I bet you it's this one he's freaking out about, actually, now that I'm thinking about it. Whatever, he'll still be called Lost Jerry. Let's trim this out. Ready? Let's trim some bush. Here we go. Woo! Oh, yeah. Rip all that forest out. Yeah, 300, 400. Not sure what dinosaur we're getting in here, but we're going to make a nice empty space for us so you guys can see sort of how much that actually does cost and sort of how just the removal thing I was talking about earlier works. Trying to overlap a little bit, get in the zoom. The other guy there, he's gonna be a little mad. He's like, I don't have enough fruit to eat. There. So yeah, about $1 million to clean that out. Gate there. And now he should stop freaking out. All right, let's go find another dinosaur. What are we gonna put in here? Something small. Let's go for the expeditions. What do we got here? Sinoceratops. Deinonychus. I'm not really sure how big those are. Parasaurolophus. Chasmosauruses and Taurus. Well, there's only two of these guys. I'm not sure how big they are, but let's do it. Oh, you know what? Hang on. I'll show you this really quick. Scientists get angry. Scientists need vacations. Paid by the company. See ya. Go to Costa Rica. There's a great place there. You're gonna love it. Let's hire a newbie here to get some stuff in here. Welfare is gonna help for healing your dinosaurs, so that probably wouldn't be a bad idea. The cost of the salary almost irrelevant for us now. Yeah, you're actually, this is a pretty nice balance of figures here. We'll take that one. Lottie Pollard. Welcome to the team, Lottie. And yeah, of course, you can change their names too. I think it's right here. Yeah, there you go. So, a lot of really nice little features in there that you can sort of give yourself as bonuses. And then I don't know exactly what that dinosaur is going to need for food, but we know they always need a little water. So you can see the height map, the contouring there, and then the game will give you some strange sort of terrain mapping to match it. And you can see there's like a little lip on there, so it's like some sort of like elevated like squid pond or some shit. I don't even know. I think it would be terrifying to try and like walk up. Turns into mud on the one bank and just slides down. It's a sludge river. All right. Oh, there's the fucking ranger just ripping in there, eh? Okay, let's get our scientists out. Oh, I should. I meant to already do that. Oops. Jump the jeep into the pond. We should. All right, generalist is needed and a... Oh, actually, you know what? We can just send the one person. We need a four. There we go. Go. Way you go. Set him up. All right, jeep. We'll get some frames there. Oh, easy there. Easy there, video card. It's all the grass. It's like, yeah, I love all the grass. There's a bit of a mud problem. Wait. Let's do one more. One more. We'll do it this way, though. Ow. Oh, my face. Oh, my face. I didn't eat fucking handlebar. Door. Open door. Open! That was close. Open door. Open door. Open door! I'm fine. It's okay. We got airbags. Apparently not. Seatbelts. Seatbelts. Where's the other dinosaur? Where's the angry ones? Let's go piss off a dinosaur. Hello, dinosaurs! There are dinosaurs in our dinosaur park, right? Let's go say hi to the guests. Apparently nobody likes the park. Dinosaurs don't like the park. The guests don't like the park. The ranger can't even figure out where anything is. Oh, there's one. There's one. Let's go hunt it. What is it? Oh, fuck. Shit. We're good. Like a glove. In the event of an accident, your face can be used as a crumple zone. There's the asshole. Hi. Composition bonus. I know how to snap a picture of an asshole.
That's what she said.
I promised last time. Oh, look, we're out of gas again. Oh, this time it's in the ranger station. Apparently we used a little bit up there driving around the car. And we'll get the food. This is for resupplying your animals with the like the goats and stuff like that. How much time on this? 20 seconds. And I think we were going to throw these guys in here. Do we have any other empty spaces? No, everything's taken. These two guys seem like they're really not going to be okay with that. We'll see how long that lasts. Even the damn cars run on Saffron. Well, it's... Hey. They're mad about Saffron. Oh, yay, we got them both. Okay, and they're kind of ugly looking, but let's throw them in here. I don't know if they'll be actually good for cohabitation. It's actually something you can really do to make nice enclosures and as well save some space. But for this, like I said, we're just gonna run through into it. Uh-oh, who's sick? Mr. Magoo. Let's get a med unit there. Go give him a scan. Go see what his problem is. let's get these guys going as well. Who's under threat?
Delivery complete. Confirming asset delivery.
All right, now we need. As requested. Hope I spelled those right. All right, what's your problems? What's your beef? What's your issue? What are you doing to your buddy there? That's not really appropriate for this kind of family program, okay? You keep that shit in your pants. Magoo got sick nibbling on the muffler. Not inaccurate. I think they need ground fiber, so let's just start with giving them some fiber. Everybody loves fiber in the diet, right? Let's make some of that. Ground leaf. Yeah, let's give you a little of that. I'm sure that'll be like at least something to start with. They'll be like, oh, I really like the fiber. Fiber's great. Leaves are wonderful. I love leaves. Where is that? There, we do have a ranger team on this one, right? Oh, yeah, there he is. It's Lost Jerry. Well, no wonder he doesn't know what he's doing. He's an idiot. See, he comes here, and then he checks the dinosaurs. He's missing a forest. We removed it. And some ground leaf. Yeah, okay. So let's get the ground leaf again. And we'll do a little guy. Ooh, and just put that right around the edge there so it sort of hides that crazy hill. And then that way when the ranger forgets about it, he's either going to drive straight into it and fly into the pond or exactly the opposite and out of it. Low health? Who's low health? Ooh. Oh, throw in some forest there. A little bit of forest. Here, we'll do that. We'll do the thinned forest. Make a bit of a larger thing here. Yeah, there you go. Perfect. Absolutely perfect. Just, you know, I designed it especially for you. All right, who's the idiot who's sick? Oh, it's you. He has tuberculosis. Do we have a research for you? Probably will. I have to go scan him. Might have to take a picture of him or something crazy like that. Who else has tuberculosis? Oh, you're sick too. Oh my goodness, what is happening here? Butthead. Yeah, that shouldn't surprise anyone. He is kind of sick, isn't he? Now who? Bloody Beavis. All right, let's get the TB meds. Go research it. This motivated, cheaper research person is really gonna help out here. We can't do a third one, but yay, saves me a little money. Make it happen. Make it happen. Go research it. Be good sauce like that. And then I think we should get another space. We're pretty close. We're 22. Let's get another couple areas built up here. Where's the edge? Over here. Yeah, let's just go this way here. Let's turn that hard edge. I don't really care too much about how this is put together exactly. It's not super important. Like I said, for these missions, like we're doing just these initial starter ones. I have already completed all of these. Not really clutch. You know, you don't have a lot of reason to make amazing spaces because these are just sort of opening areas. There are a lot more incentives for when you're playing in the games, like achievement modes and mission modes and things like that to help make incentive, as it were, for good paddocks to make good spaces for your dinosaurs, because it's you know, you want to win, as it were, right? So for this one though, plenty fine. We'll let that start running and then we can get built and we'll start looking for another dinosaur. This is the one we're looking for. There we go. What do we got? Torosaurus, Sinoceratops, Parasaurolophus, and Deinonychus. Let's do this one. Let's do that one. Send those two. Way you go. And there goes their helicopter. Private helicopter, off to go collect some dinosaurs inside the United States. Don't spend too much or we will take it out of your salary. Oh, good. The doc is here. Let's go administer some medications via the old airsoft rifle. You can get a shot. I don't know if there's any more over there. I think it's just you guys over here. Where are they? Wait, isn't there two here? Oh, no. One of them apparently just got better on his own, I guess. All right, whatever. I don't understand, but sure, let's go with it. Maybe he was sick with the Cryptosporidosis. So look at it again, Jesus. Fill it up. Another half mil. Bing, gone. Evaporated. Really, Scooty? Really, buddy? What is your deal now? What is your issue?
Why are you being so stupid?
Which destination are you not able to reach? I don't understand. Whatever. Medicating Mr. Magoo. Medicate these two butt chucklers. Here comes the dinies. How many are we getting? Oh, he's kind of creepy looking. Oh, we got all four. I think these are Mita sort of Gnosis's. Transport. Was it this? Yes.
Asset in transit. Asset
all
transportation.
Right, let's add in a little
underway.
Bit of water. A little bit of water. Let's throw it right over here. It's a little birch. There we go.
Asset has been delivered.
How many bloody dinosaurs are getting tuberculosis? My God, if I could name the park, I'd call
asset
it tuberculosis
delivered.
Land. Look at all of them. They landed and they caught it. Landed, it's just in the air. It's the miasma. It's the night miasmas getting in and causing these issues. I think what we really need here is a witch doctor to come and assess this in a way that they could exercise some sort of voodoo, you know. Lost Jerry, come here, buddy. Go do your thing. Fucking nitwit. All right, let's feed these things some goats. Do they want goats? I don't know if they want goats. We're gonna need to name these guys as well. I have no idea what these elite. Goats or meat raw, I'm not sure. Let's find out. Let's wait for Lost Jerry to show up. Give him a few seconds here. Where is he? Jerry, here he comes. He's gonna bust through those trees like a boss. Right through the tree. See, like I said, an idiot stick. All right, he is looking for food in the form of meat. Interesting. All right, so you like the meat. Let's add meat, and let's add another meat here. There you go, lots of meat. Now he's also upset about the lack of water, but remember we threw that in over here, and he's also a little pissed about the lack of forest, but it looks pretty close. So I'm gonna just give him a few seconds to wander around. And yeah, there you go. See, you just needed to figure your shit out. There you go. Oh, I should probably send the med. Go give him a fucking shot of the old TB meds. There you go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Who's the last one? Who is it? Who's the other? Who's the standout? Probably asshole, isn't it? No. Oh, I just missed it. I see it's in the forest here. Unreachable by vehicle. You think? Kind of looks a little bit difficult, doesn't it? Add it in anyways. We'll see how he does. Now we had, what, four of those guys? Oops. All right. So we've got, not the carnivore feeder. Don't name the fucking feeder. Name the dinosaur. So this is, who's the boss? That would be Angela. She's the boss. We know that. And there's Tony. Right, Tony, and then there's the other one, Mona. What was the name of one of the kids? Give me one of the kids' names. Fuck, I don't remember it. Shit. I'm gonna look it up. I'm kind of curious. I was doing so well. Who's the boss? American sitcom. What was it? Was it though? Oh yeah, right, the Bauer family. Oh my God. Such a name. Where, Jonathan, that was the boy. And Samantha, that was the name of Alyssa Milano. Here, we'll give her that one. She, oh, guys, it's another tornado. Nothing says Jurassic Park like a like. Look at this. Whatever building that is being absolutely shredded. Science Center.
I got your science right here, Doctor.
Oh, it's a little eye. Thank God for that. All right, Scooty. Wait. But.
Calm and collected. That's how I live my life. Other than, you know, when I'm being chased by dinosaurs or molten lava.
I know! Wait. But.
Calm and collected. That's how I live my life. Other than, you know, when I'm being chased by dinosaurs or molten lava.
Now you know why I wanted to share this with you guys. What a game. All right, let's go get our repair, guys. This one's still active, right? Yeah. Jerry, we need you to do some stuff here, buddy. We need you to fix Jurassic Park. Could you come fix this response facility first, and then they can go and fix other things? Oh, Lord. Well, that was amazing. Owen Grady, Adventure Specialist. All right, now that this building's gonna be fixed, because, you know, all just takes is a little bit of time, love, and just a quick trip over. Scooty, we'll have him do the other stuff here. Amazing. Absolutely amazing. What do we need? Couple hundred point here, and then we'll be up at the score we need. Oh, do you know what? I'm brain fart. I didn't put any visibility guy thingies on here. I got one here, but I didn't put here for the other ones. Shit fart. Hang on. We actually put dinosaurs in there. Oh yeah, that was the Torosauruses or whatever the hell it was. Okay, there, and then, you know, I wonder. Brain, I'm smart, I can do this. All right, do you guys like the other dude, the one next door, tallest guy, Mr. Magoo? He likes Ankies. He's, you know what, he'd be okay with that. You know what, let's just do it. I'm gonna take that right up. There we go. That's cohabitation. Ta-da-na-na. And we're gonna take this, and we're just gonna move it down. Right about there. And then, ooh, look at this Garden State kind of quality pathing here. Right through the shit there. Nice. There we go. So then, yeah, that should actually help to increase our appeal rating. Because that's essentially what we're trying to do, is increase that appeal. Yes, the local dinosaur appeal, 142. And now we're at 2,400. And we'll get these guys as well. We have one here? Yeah, we do there, but not for those ones. Okay, let's throw a viewing gallery in here. That might have been all we were missing here. We went ahead. As it were, too many dinosaurs. You know what, here, let's do this really quick. This is a nice one here. We'll just do that, and then we can, oops. Trying to manage some of the stuff here. We'll go about to there. Yeah, I know it's not. And just like that, nice little curved path in there. Isn't that a great tool? Look at how slick that was, hey? If that was City Skylines, I'm not lying. Paradox, take a note on this one. Or Colossal Order, whoever built that pathing tool. That's how you build a pathing tool. That's it. That's fucking lessons, man. And then, let me show you, actually. Let me just show you the crazy awesomeness, okay? So we're working on a curve. We're out of gas again. Okay, so you're like, okay, I could build straight off of it, of course, snap to grid. I can hit the shift key. So now it's the straight direct line. Okay, and I can choose to add, you see what I've done here? Additional path. Like walking space, sort of a bad one because I did it on an angle, but that becomes just like more road, as it were. And you can do that, and you can just add more walking space, which is a thing, and we'll get to it. Oh, Kenny, nice. Thank you for that. Definitely putting that on the socials. Amazing. There we go. Fill up the gas tanks again. Another 500,000 out the fucking kisser. We'll go get the other gas station while we're at it. And fill that one up too, just so we have them both done. There we are. All right. Oh yeah. See, and we're gonna wrap this up really quickly here. 29:29, and it's like right at wrap up time too. So that's pretty convenient. So now we'll just wait for this to tick over, I guess. Hopefully it does. If not, we'll just go find a dinosaur, pick it up. Actually, you know what? Let's do it anyways. You go get a thing. Go pick one up. What do we got? Sinoceratops, Parasaural Office, or Tor. You know what? Let's get these guys. Five of these guys. Oh, yeah. I think we already have those. Whatever. Go get it. Make it happen. You done with it? Can I hope? Of course, I send them off and we're going to finish in the meantime. Watch that. Maybe not. But yeah, this was mission number three. Shove them in asshole's pen to end it. I like that idea. Where is he? Somewhere over here. There he is. There's the asshole. He's such an asshole. Aren't you? Yeah, sit down. Relax. You're gonna need it. You're gonna go for the fight of your life. Dun, 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 dun. Here they come. I thought that said Klingon at first. Jesus. All five. It's a 5v1. Here we go. I'm gonna throw them on this side though.
Assets
right in front of the viewing gallery.
Transportation underway.
Alright. And now we'll see if I mostly wanted to click over and just be done with it. But if we have a few seconds to watch it happen, well, we will.
Asset delivery confirmed. Asset has been transported.
He smells something. There's something in the water. It just ain't right. Oh, the Torosauruses are fighting each other. They just are like, fuck this shit. I hate everyone. You're gonna go charging through the fence right away here. An undiagnosed ailment. Yeah, they fought each other. That's their ailment. They're stupid. 2919. There's 3,000. Yay!
Okay.
Here's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna pause it right here because when we finish this mission next week, it's gonna roll into the next campaign. And so we'll allow it to do that. But I'm actually gonna stop right here because there's just a tiny bit of stuff I'm sure left to do. It's gonna be like, have like 8 species of dinosaur, ensure all comfort, and then that'll be it. So we'll come back to this wonderful, crazy, fun little game. Isn't that nice? Isn't this good? I really encourage if you like sandbox games and you enjoyed the Zoo Tycoon, the Roller Coaster Tycoon, and of course Jurassic Park is literally the overarching theme here. If those are sort of your avenue, pick the game up. It is really fun. I very much enjoyed it. There is a couple of DLCs. One gives like a Cretaceous pack, so it's like a bunch of Cretaceous era dinosaurs, and I forget the other one. Honestly, but they're not expensive. Go pick them up tomorrow. Friday night, Smite. We're going to get back into that. I think we're going to have Polite Canuck running in the assault lane for us. We'll see. I'm sure he's more than ready. I've been warming the guy up all week. He is fucking ready to go. He should be able to kick some ass if he does. Thank you, Ken, for the link. Appreciate that. We're going to have that for you guys tomorrow. 11 o'clock Mountain, we're going to have that. Saturday, City Skylines. We're going to return to our cold city build. We're going to have that for you guys. And then Sunday, we're back with Arthur Morgan again in Red Dead Redemption. And by the way, if you haven't joined my posse, I'd love to have you in there. If you're in Red Dead Online, shoot me a message at Original Webcam. I mean, gee, really, that's fucking,
that's your handle, eh? Fuck, that's crazy talk.
Anyway, good night, ladies, gentlemen, everyone. Thank you for joining me for this inaugural play of the Jurassic World Evolution 2. Very fun game, and I'm very happy to bring this to you guys again next week. Till tomorrow, see you then. Yeah, I noticed that too. It's a video display setting. I'm going to fix it after. It's just like the line syncs and stuff. Have a good night, guys.